No surprises then that St James's Park is absolutely rocking at the Gallow Gate end. There's a sign held up, Eddie Howe's Black and White Army, together with a flag of, or a tifo really, of Eddie Howe's face there in celebration. The players are out in front of us right now. What a sight St James's Park always is. It's such a pleasure to be here all the time, whenever you come here, be it the Premier League, in Europe, whatever it might be. A fantastic ground for football. This is a fantastic Saturday afternoon to restart the Premier League for the final straight. Easter weekend is all about the resurrection of Jesus Christ, isn't it? How he came back from the dead. Can the Black and White Toon Army do the same? Can they revive and resurrect their season as we head into the final straight of the campaign? As we were hearing, they've scored in every single Premier League home game so far this season. In fact, three quarters of their total point tally have been gained here at home. That certainly bodes well, given the Hammers have lost four of their six away games in all competitions in 2024. They're unbeaten in their last four top flight matches as well, but seeing as four is the magic number, they've failed to win any of the four Premier League matches that they've played this season without Edson Álvarez. So many possibilities today. Who will the omens favour today? Dean Ashton has called it a draw. Could go either way. Which side will close the Easter weekend the happier of bunnies? Should be a great game here as we restart the Premier League with a bang. Let's find out how this one pans out then in the company of the former Norwich, West Ham and England striker Dean Ashton. But first, your match commentator today, Adam Bridge.
Thank you, Reshmin. Good afternoon and welcome. A beautiful afternoon in Newcastle. The floodlights are on, but they're not required. There's blue sky above, some white clouds as well. And with just 6 points separating 7th and 12th, the quest for European football has never been fiercer. The Magpies' foray into the Champions League after a 20-year absence may have ended prematurely at the hands of a dodgy refereeing decision, but the Toon Army have had a taste of dining at Europe's top table again and now do anything to be back there next season. Although Europe's elite competition is out of reach, Eddie Howe said we'll embrace whatever we can get. And today's opponents are living proof of that attitude, having gained a first European trophy in 58 years as conference champions. And after three straight European adventures, travelling over land and sea, West Ham won't want to give that up easily. With the unbeaten Bayer Leverkusen lying wait in the Europa League quarter-final, it seems that seventh place for them could be the Holy Grail and their best hope of another European adventure. The countdown to the end of the season starts here with Newcastle United against West Ham United at St James's Park. The Newcastle United side, one change from that FA Cup quarter-final defeat against Manchester City, and Sven Botman obviously absent through injury. Tino Livramento comes in. Dubravka's in goal. Livramento, Lascelles, Cher and Byrne across the back. Longstaff, Guimaraes and Willock in midfield with Murphy, Isak and Gordon up top. As for West Ham, one change for them as well. Alves is suspended. Ward-Prowse starts. So Areola's in goal. Sofal, Mavropanos, Zuma and Emerson across the back. Ward-Prowse and Socek in midfield with Bowen, Paquetar and Kudus providing the support to Mikel Antonio, who will lead the line today. Our referee is Rob Jones. The last game here that he refereed was a 1-0 win over Manchester United back in December. At that point, Newcastle went fifth, 2 points off the top four. They're now 16 points away. Oh, how a season can change just like that. Rob Jones is the man in orange and we're underway, and it's going to be West Ham who have the first goal kick of the game away to our left-hand side. Dean Ashton, you've played here, you've scored here. What kind of atmosphere is this to play football in?
A ridiculous one, a special one for any player. Can't imagine what it must be like to play here as a home player every other week. Always special.
Special to score too.
You can tell us about the goal later, because you did tell me this morning it was quite a special one.
Yeah, like them all.
Here's Ward-Prowse in the East centre circle. Missed his first game of the season in the Premier League against Aston Villa, where he's demoted to the substitutes bench. Early touch for Kudus back inside his own half, where Socek awaits. And here's Mavropanos out wide on this right-hand side, who easily finds Sofal. And again, it's back to Alphonse Areola away to our left-hand side. Four clean sheets to his name in this Premier League campaign, but just one clean sheet on the road this season. That came in that victory over Arsenal at the end of December. Apart from that, that defence gets breached every time they travel. And that will be a welcome statistic for Newcastle United, who themselves have scored, as we said, in every single home game this Premier League campaign. Lascelles has the ball midway inside his own half on that right-hand side for Newcastle United. They are defending the Gallagher end in this opening 45 minutes. Here is Sofal down this right-hand side for West Ham. Looks to play the ball in towards Jared Bowen, but easily read by Fabian Scher, who's away down this left-hand side. He gets it out wide to Anthony Gordon. Gordon now cutting infield on his right foot, then goes on his left. Now dancing inside the penalty area. Gordon does brilliantly and gets it across towards the edge of the six-yard box, and there's a penalty. It's a penalty for Newcastle United. And the challenge from Vladimir Sofal is penalised. Anthony Gordon, the player that's gone down. And Rob Jones, no hesitation, immediately points to the spot.
Yeah, I can't see this being anything other than a penalty. He's made the decision, Sofal, to go for the challenge, to go for the ball, to dive in front of Anthony Gordon, and Anthony Gordon just gets there first. He just steps across to try and shield the ball, Gordon, and Sofal just goes right through the back of his calf. It's definitely a penalty, and David Moyes' reaction right in front of us to turn away, shrug his shoulders. Can't believe that his defenders made that decision so early.
Well, it's the first Newcastle penalty against West Ham United since 2007. On that day, Norberto Solano took the spot kick for Newcastle. And Rob Jones, obviously in conversation with VAR, but I can see no reason why this would be overturned at all. There's plenty of contact.
Yeah, it's the easiest penalty decision of the season. So fouls. Taking the choice to try and make the challenge. Anthony Gordon's just too quick and got there first. He's clattered right through the back of his calf, and this will be a penalty, I'm pretty sure of it, unless there's some tiny offside that they've found.
Well, that's probably what they're looking for at the moment, and it is a possible offside they're looking at. Probably the ball went... Anthony Gordon obviously laid the ball in to Scher, and it's just a question there whether Gordon's come back from an offside position, I'm guessing, Dean?
Well, it's played into Fabian Scher, into the penalty area by Gordon. And then when Scher takes that first touch, which is then intercepted, but he takes that first touch, and it's just whether Anthony Gordon has stepped away, which Fabian Scher's... the ball's not going anywhere near Anthony Gordon. He just takes a touch. Mavropanos then touches the ball last. I don't see how, with Fabian Scher's touch nowhere near Gordon, a deliberate act from Mavropanos.
Well, we're 4 minutes into the game here on Talksport, game day exclusive, coming to you live from St James's Park, and we already have our first VAR moment of the weekend. And it's a moment where it's taking their time looking at this potential offside. And referee Rob Jones is in deep conversation with Anthony Gordon, explaining what's going on right now. David Coote is the VAR official back at Stockley Park, and that can be the only thing that he's coming back from an offside position potentially.
I think he is going to be offside if from the touch from Fabian Scher, but Fabian Scher's touch doesn't go anywhere near Gordon, and then Mavropanos just steps in and blocks it away,
and it is a penalty. Alexander Isak will be the player who steps up for Newcastle United. 5 minutes on the clock. What a perfect start this would be for Newcastle United. We talked about a reset from the international break, having lost in that FA Cup quarter-final. Isak with the ball on the spot. He scored two against West Ham back in October, and he's got a chance to put Newcastle United ahead, and he sends Adeola the wrong way, and he tucks the ball into his bottom left-hand corner, and St James's Park rises. They have the lead with 5 minutes on the clock. Alexander Isak with a penalty. Vladimir Sofal, the man who committed the foul on Anthony Gordon. But it's a perfect start for Newcastle. It's a perfect start for Eddie Howe, and perfect for the Toon Army. Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 0.
Well, he does send Adeola the wrong way, but it wouldn't have mattered if he'd gone the right way, because this kisses on the inside of the post, this penalty. It's absolutely perfect. It's got the pace, it's got the accuracy. Maybe he probably feels a little sigh of relief that it didn't come back at him. Great penalty from Isak.
13th Premier League goal of the season for Isak. 6 in his last 8 Premier League games. He has actually lost 4 of those, having scored in those matches. He'll be hoping that's not the case today, but it's the perfect start under the blue skies of Newcastle. And this stadium absolutely erupting early on. Here's Antonio down that left-hand side now. How will West Ham respond? Well, he's trying to use his physical presence to get through, which he does brilliantly, and then tries to cross the ball, but it's poor, and it's out of play for a goal kick away to our right-hand side.
Yeah, first bit was brilliant from Antonio. Lovely little nutmeg over on that far side, and then just got it onto his left foot. Little nudge as he was about to try and cross it in, I think, and that's why it spooned wide, but didn't take long, did it, for those stats that you reeled off with Newcastle scoring here and West Ham conceding for that to come to fruition.
You know, it's unbelievable the amount of goals they have scored here, obviously. They've won 9 of their home games already this season. The last time they've won 10 by the time they played 15 at home was over 20 years ago. It just shows what a fortress this is. But you say that, they have dropped 10 points in their last 5 home games. So they've not been in the best of form more recently. Plenty of draws without too many defeats, of course. They've got some defending to do, as Bowen's going to put Cher under some pressure here at the edge of his own penalty area as the sun comes out, bathing this wonderful arena this afternoon. And VAR took nearly 2 minutes, 1 minute 53, to make that decision about the offside call. I mean, you spotted very quickly. He wasn't really interfering, was he? It was played by a West Ham player, so surely it shouldn't have taken 2 minutes.
It shouldn't. It was obvious that the touch was nowhere near Gordon. It was obvious that Mavropanos made a deliberate act to block the ball.
The ball by Isak out wide to that right-hand side. Livramento charging forward from his right full-back position. He's a good addition for Newcastle United today. They very much missed him in that game against Man City, reverting to the back three. They're in the flat back four today, and they've got work to do now. Bowen down this right-hand side for West Ham United, towards the corner flag, and the challenge comes in from Dan Byrne. Throw's going to be taken quickly by Sofal, and Byrne gets up and heads it straight out of play and behind what will be a corner to West Ham on the right-hand side.
Well, it's an area of weakness. There's no doubt in recent games Dan Byrne has been questioned his place in the team. I think of Benny in particular of Luton, really gave him a difficult afternoon here at St James's Park. But I think he's got the character to get on with it, but it's an area Bowen will look to exploit.
Well, Ward-Prowse is not on this this corner, should I say. It's going to be swung in by the left boot of Jared Bowen instead, and it's swung towards the near post looking for Antonio, who have made the run across the penalty area. Headed away that time though by Murphy, and now delivered back in by Paquetar, and it's towards Zuma, but it's a good header away at the edge of the 6-yard box that time. And once more on that far side, West Ham come again. Emerson gets the ball across, peppering the Newcastle United penalty area with crosses, and in the end they can just put the ball out of play on the far side for a throw to West Ham United.
Yeah, lovely quality from Paquetar. First of all, the cross from that side was brilliant into a great area. Fabian Cher with a terrific header in front of Antonio, and then a couple of step overs once it came back out to Paquetar to feed it into Emerson down the side. Didn't get his head up properly, just fed it in low and was easily blocked. Needed to get his head up, spot a run from a teammate.
This is Newcastle United against West Ham United from St James's Park on game day exclusive on Talksport. Here's Anthony Gordon away with room to run into down the left hand side. Goes infield instead, and he picks out Willock. Willock plays the ball square to the right hand edge of the penalty area. Murphy's there. Murphy twisting and turning, looks for support, and he lays it into the penalty area, just trying to get a shot away. On the turn was Isak, and he does. He blasts it over the top of the crossbar. Good play from Newcastle United, cutting West Ham open at will.
Yeah, bit of fortune in the end for Isak, the way it fell to him. It was long stuff. He tried to stab it past Zuma. The deflection fell kindly for Isak on the side, winding half volley, and just a fraction over. Decent hit. But, you know, you talk about Alvarez not playing for West Ham. That area could be so key. Who is it going to be that sits there? Is it Ward-Prowse or is it Socek?
Here's Bowen on the charge infield in towards Antonio, towards the edge of the penalty area, and out comes Dubravka and collects away to our right-hand side. And, well, this is something that Newcastle United fans never want to see. And it's Jamel Lascelles, he's down, and, well, immediately they've called the trainer on here. He was banging the floor in frustration and pain then.
Yeah, I mean,
that was Antonio, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Just the way he collapsed, you could just see as if his knee got caught between Antonio's legs, and I think probably because of that, as it's twisted in the turf as well, he looked in a lot of discomfort. The way you can tell with the knees as well, players just collapse, they don't take another step.
Well, Sean Longstaff has immediately signalled the lifter the sign of a stretcher to the Newcastle United bench, and that there's going to be a potential substitution to come here. Just 11 and a half minutes into the game, of course, they lost Sven Botman to that knee surgery following the Manchester City FA Cup quarter-final, and Longstaff now coming over just to talk to Willock and Isak and the coaching staff about the problem that the Sells have suffered. I suppose one of the options here is potentially to move Dan Byrne into the middle. Would that be one of the options that's available to them?
It is an option, but they don't, they've rarely done that. They've rarely used Dan Byrne as a centre-back. And you wonder why, because he has played in that position. He's left-sided as well, which would keep the balance of that defensive pair. But he tends to bring usually Emil Kraft on.
Kraft, yeah. Dummett's amongst the substitutes as well. You're listening to Newcastle versus West Ham on Talksport with Now. Don't forget that you can now, with Now, you can stream all the Sky Sports action like Aston Villa against Wolves and Brentford against Manchester United live today, contract-free with a Now Sports membership. Search Now Sports. Well, the stretcher is being brought on. It gives me a chance to tell you about the rest of the live football coming up today here on Talksport. Spurs against Luton is our second live and exclusive commentary from the Premier League. That's on Talksport this afternoon. Adrian Durham will be at the City Ground, and he'll bring you all the goals as they go in. And the rest of the Premier League games taking place this afternoon. There's five games kicking off at 3 o'clock this afternoon. And a reminder tonight at 8, Brentford against Manchester United. Brentford not out of the danger zone, and United desperately trying to chase down those in fourth and fifth place in the Premier League. That's our live game tonight from 8 o'clock, exclusive to Talk Sport. Well, the stretcher's been sent away, which I think is always a good sign, but I don't think we're going to see it. Well, they're now trying to flex his knee away to our right-hand side. I mean, you've had some injuries in your time as well. The way he went down, like you say, there was no movement afterwards, was there? It was literally straight to the ground.
I mean, I don't think he seemed the type of player to kind of go down and have the reaction that he did, where he was kind of punching the grass if there wasn't a serious problem. I mean, the way he's got, so I'd be amazed if he can carry on.
He made his 250th appearance for Newcastle against Manchester City in that FA Cup tie. And you think he only started two Premier League games last season, but obviously with the injury woes that Newcastle United have had, he's been far more prominent this time round. It's his 13th start of the campaign today. Well, he is walking off gingerly without any assistance, but I do think, yeah,
I think that says more about him as a character, that he wouldn't want to get stretched off. He'd want to give himself every chance. But you know, this is where the medical team have to be absolutely spot on, because what you wouldn't want to do now is go on and do even further damage.
Yeah, Jason Tindall just preparing Emil Kraft down below. It's Dubravka who's going to have the ball in the penalty area away to our right-hand side. Well, we've had 14 and a half minutes of the game, but not too much football so far, Dean. In that time, Newcastle United have scored a penalty. Alexander Isak on target with that, if you are just joining us here on TalkSport. So it's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 0, a win that could move them up to 8th in the table, Newcastle United. There's a foul there, and we're going to see Lascelles now coming back on the field of play very gingerly. And a tremendous round of applause from those inside St James's Park for Jamal Lascelles as he makes his way out. I think Eddie Howe concerned that he may do himself more damage here, but they're going to give it a go.
I bet you any money he won't stay on. He won't. I just can't see. I can't see how you can after the way he reacted from that incident.
Burn out wide to the left-hand side. Anthony Gordon, who's seen plenty of the ball already, won the penalty for Newcastle United. Isak gets it out wide to that right-hand side. Livramento's there, closed down by Kudus. Forward he goes towards Murphy. Then Longstaff. Longstaff into the feet of Isak. Well read, though, by the feet of Kurt Zouma, just 10 yards outside his own penalty area. And Mavropanos will clip a long ball over the top that Bowen's going to try and chase down against Dan Byrne here. He's back facing Dubravka. Just turns away from Bowen. Then cuts inside him. And that's well done by Dan Byrne. Gimenez is there and goes back inside his own penalty area. Dubravka at the edge of his six-yard box out on the right-hand edge, and he just played the ball straight into touch, and it'll be a West Ham United throw on the far side. Eddie Howe not happy, and they are going to make the substitution, and Lascelles will depart, and Emil Kraft will come on. Eighth time this season he's come on as a substitute, yet to start a game for Newcastle United, and Jamal Lascelles, the unfortunate man who will depart.
I just think that's a little bit of weakness from the medical staff to allow him to go back on. A little bit too much pride from Jamal Lascelles to try and go back on. That was so obvious that there was a real issue. It's a real shame for him because he's had his injury problems throughout his Newcastle career. This would have been an opportunity with Botman out as well.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's had a torrid time over the years, hasn't he, with injuries. So you can understand his frustration. He's talking to Eddie Howe saying, oh, it doesn't feel too bad, but he's gone and sat down and Emil Kraft is on and he'll immediately have work to do because West Ham have possession with a throw on that far side, midway inside the Newcastle United half, and Dubravka put the ball out of play and therefore it's been given back to Newcastle United, and it will be Newcastle to bring it clear from inside their own penalty area down this left-hand side.
Well, what they have done is Dan Byrne has gone to that left-hand side centre-back. Kraft has gone to right-back and Livramento's come over here to left-back.
Reshuffle, we thought they might move Dan Byrne. Here's Socek in the middle of the park, gets it up towards Antonio, who does well, spins away Antonio on the left foot, just over the top of the crossbar. The effort from the edge of the penalty area, never really troubling Dubravka, but it was a good setup play. Antonio made his own chance.
Yeah, maybe that's why Dan Byrne isn't playing centre back very regularly. He's just gone to try and win the ball when he shouldn't have. Antonio just flicked it around the side of him and was away from him. Dan Byrne totally out of the game. And Antonio, I just thought he made the wrong decision there. Yes, the shot was on, but it was on his weaker side. He had Paquetá just to his left as well. He probably could have taken it on a couple more strides and drifted it onto his right foot as well. Just snatched slightly of that chance over the top.
I would say with Antonio, it's been a confidence issue not scoring goals, but he doesn't come across as a man who lacks any kind of confidence, does he, Dean?
No, I think he's that type of player as well. I think he will go periods where he doesn't score.
Here's Ward-Prowse charging forward through the centre circle, dispossessed by Guimaraes, and it goes back to Cher and then to Byrne at the edge of the penalty area away to our right hand side. That was Antonio's goal against Villa, his first since August in the Premier League for West Ham United. Byrne will get a clearance forward up towards halfway. Mavropanos wins the header down towards Socek, but it's Willock who wins it on the floor this time, and then it's given away by Isak to Paquetá, who lifts the ball out wide to the left hand side where Emerson is waiting 10 yards inside the Newcastle half. Paquetá, who played both games midweek in the international break for Brazil, scored a late penalty to get a 3-3 draw against Spain, and of course featured in Brazil's win over England at Wembley. Here's Mavropanos to the right hand side. Sofal is there again, he'll go back to Mavropanos. Areola being the only option really available for the West Ham United goalkeeper, he's the West Ham United goalkeeper, and he lifts it forward to the far side to try and find Kudus, but the header down falls nicely for Murphy. Isak inside the penalty area again on that far side. Willock's in there as well. Isak does the hard work, finds Murphy at the edge of the penalty area. Here's Gordon, slips it towards Willock, and then good challenge from Zuma. Here's Livramento, finds Gordon, angle in the penalty area, tries to bend one on his right foot. Socek gets the block in. Kudus at the edge of his own penalty area. He's closed down by Longstaff on that far side, but he gets the ball out and gets it as far as Emerson, and West Ham now will have time and space to clear.
Terrific tackle in there from Kurt Zuma. Came across, swap sides with Mavropanos just for a moment. Had to make the challenge when Willock looked like he was about to take the strike.
Kudus loses possession on halfway. It's picked up by Ward-Prowse. Paquetá then lifts the ball over the top. Antonio, he's onside here. Antonio through against Dubravka. Antonio for West Ham United. It's one apiece. Mikel Antonio, back-to-back Premier League goals. He scored against Villa in India before the international break. And now he's scored against Newcastle United. And with 20 minutes gone here, where we predicted goals, it's Newcastle 1, West Ham 1.
Well, he didn't snatch at this one, did he, Antonio? Once he got through, he took his time. He knew he was going to be under pressure from Kraft in the end, but he just picked his spot. Firm side foot past Dubravka. Nothing the goalkeeper could do. It's a terrific finish. This will be checked, of course it will, by VAR for the offside, because it must be tight. But I tell you what, when you have the vision of Paquetá and Newcastle don't put pressure on, the defence have to drop. They absolutely have to drop. Rule 101 of defending. When no pressure on the ball, you have to drop as a defence. They don't. Antonio knows that Paquetá's got the vision. Lovely little flick pass over the top from Paquetá into Antonio's path. He takes a really nice first touch, steadies himself. Firm side foot in the back of the net.
21 minutes played here. Well, we said goals, didn't we?
Well, you did.
We've already had two. Yeah, we've had two already in the opening 21 minutes. One apiece then. Antonio just about onside. It's a fourth Premier League goal of the season for Mikel Antonio. Long time out with an injury, of course. He was supposed to go and play for Jamaica in the international break, but he pulled out. And that will be good news for David Moyes because he looks fit and raring to go. Change of boots just down below for Joe Willock. He's back on the field of play. And Willock does seem to have come off on his right boot, so that's why he had to have the change of footwear. Here's Gordon down this left-hand side. It meant they were down to 10 men for a moment, but they're back up to full capacity now. Guimaraes for Newcastle United. How will the home side respond? They are used to conceding here, as we mentioned. Clean sheets, not something these two sides know much about. Guimaraes down that right-hand side. Lovely ball slipped in. It's across by Kraft and it's cleared away. Areola was there. Now a chance maybe for Paquetá to get it clear at the edge of the penalty area, but he's fouled in the process.
Well, Kudus just doesn't do his defensive work on that side. He switches off, he turns his back, he doesn't see the run of Kraft, who just gets beyond him. And again, a little bit like Emerson earlier on in the game, you've got to get your head up and actually pick a teammate out, not just fire it across every time. Good positioning from Mavropanos. And then Paquetá, so clever in winning a free kick just to relieve the pressure.
Well, we did say the race for seventh was going to be fierce. Well, it's been a fierce opening quarter of the game here on Talksport. Game day exclusive, live from St James's Park, where it remains Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 1. Here's Paquetá. He just holds off the challenge of Guimaraes, who then takes Paquetá to the floor. The referee says play on, which they have, and here's Murphy slipping in Gordon. Anthony Gordon down this left-hand side, inside the penalty area. On his right, tries to pick its spot, and Areola goes down and makes the save. Paquetá still down. I think he's claiming a hand in his jaw from Bruno Guimaraes, but referee Rob Jones saw nothing in it and played on.
No, he just felt as if Paquetá was a bit weak. It's just whether there was an arm across. Usually these are given as a free kick now. If a player steps across with the arm into the opposition's face, Paquetá, lovely little swivel to start with. Good strength away from Guimaraes, and actually got a monitor in front of us and there's barely any contact. It might be a little fingernail to the cheek there from Guimaraes. How dare he?
There's of course a busy Easter weekend of football across the TalkSport network. We were in the EFL and the Championship yesterday. We brought you four live commentaries from the Championship. We have four of those for you again on Easter Monday as well, and they form part of the over 50 live commentaries across the TalkSport network coming up in April. Here's Kudus with a shot, and it just spoons up in the air, and Dubravka will comfortably make the save.
Just a different team when they have this front four fit, West Ham. Such a danger. Every single attack, they look like they could get something, usually even just from a ball from nothing, because Antonio gives you that. He will literally chase anything, even in that last attack where Kudus gets a shot off. That all started because Antonio just didn't give up the ball going in towards the corner. Livramento cleared it, then found itself to Kudus, who took the snapshot.
Here is Livramento, short into Gordon, now continues his run. Antonio's tracking, so fouling with the challenge, and Suchek's going to let that run out of play away to our left-hand side for a goal kick to West Ham United. You're listening to Newcastle against West Ham on TalkSport with Super 6. Predict six correct scores from this weekend's action and you could win £1 million without spending a penny. 20 minutes remaining in this first half, although I suspect we'll be looking at probably 6 or 7 minutes to be added after the VAR check and the injury to Lascelles in the opening exchanges in this game. We have had time for two goals though, one apiece. So far the two checks combine on this right hand side, but the throw in goes the way of Newcastle United and it'll be taken by Livramento, who started the game at right back. He's now playing on this left side, the Southampton pick up from the summer, of course, one of some fairly expensive signings in this Newcastle United side. It's only when you actually look through it and look at some of the transfer fees paid, they're all carrying fairly hefty price tags.
Well, the bank's a little fuller now here at St James's Park.
Yeah, they just can't spend any of it at the moment, can they? That's the problem. There's Byrne. Oh, gives it away. Socek now a chance down this right-hand side for Bowen to charge. 14 Premier League goals to his name already this season as Jared Bowen. Seven of them away from the London Stadium, but he's dispossessed that time by Willock, who tries to bend one with the outside of his right foot, but it's intercepted by Mavropanos and goes all the way back to Adeola, away to our left-hand side.
Yeah, they've just been a bit sloppy, haven't they, Newcastle, since the injury to Jamal Lascelles and the reshuffle. They've not been as good as they started the game. They just keep giving the ball away to West Ham, which is where they'll be most dangerous.
You know, the distribution from Byrne occasionally not up to scratch so far. Antonio's pressing here, but no one else really joining him, so Newcastle easily break out and play through with Longstaff. Gordon on this left-hand touchline, about 25 yards from goal, cuts in on towards that right foot, the willowy figure of Gordon. Then he finds Longstaff again. Livramento, Gordon, 25 yards out, again trying to work it onto his right foot. Guimaraes spreads it to that far side, the right. Kraft is out there. Infield he goes once more, and it's picked up this time by Murphy, 25, 30 yards from goal. Guimaraes again, coming forward down that far side. Kraft is hugging the touchline on that far side, but again, Newcastle United just happy to play the ball around. Now they go with some pace. Good challenge from Ward-Prowse. Wins it back for West Ham. Kudus now trying to break on the counter, but he's fouled in the process, and that may well be... Is he thinking of the first card? No, I think he's turning around and saying that's the first foul. It was, I think, Kraft that may have committed it that time, but David Moyes furious.
He is, yeah. He's not happy, is he? Because it was a counter-attack that Kraft most definitely stopped. And again, throughout the season, we tend to see that as a yellow card. So we got away one there.
Here's the free kick, and it will be taken by Alphonse Areola. And it's probably about 15, 20 yards short of halfway. You're listening to Game Day Exclusive on TalkSport, where it's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 1. The race for seventh spot and European qualification for next season is well and truly underway. Here's Kudus down that left-hand side, gets to the byline, cuts it back towards Bowen inside the penalty area, just gets caught under his feet, and he was offside anyway, according to the assistant on this near side. And it will be a free kick for Newcastle United. Dean Ashton.
Yeah, again, when they move the ball quickly, they've got the fastest direct speed in the Premier League, West Ham, in terms of metres per second once they win the ball back. That is difficult to defend against. You have to be set. You have to be organised. You have to make sure there's communication between the back line, which at the moment is just a totally fresh, probably never played before, back four for Newcastle, and they're just trying to get to grips with that.
It's funny you talk about their pace, because these are two of the three oldest starting lineups, average age starting lineups in the Premier League this season. Only Fulham have got older than these two compared to some of those young guns, but they do still have plenty of pace on offer, both teams.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, it's a feature. I think Newcastle would probably prefer to be a counter-attacking team.
Isak to Gordon down this left-hand side, controlled it nicely on the run inside the penalty area. Gordon on his right foot pulls it back. Bowen's there to try and clear. Guimaraes picks it up. Livramento on this left-hand side. He's got Bowen just trying to close him down and force him backwards, which he does. Guimaraes again out wide to that right-hand side this time. Kraft is there. Forward of him is Murphy. Murphy cutting infield. Orange boots shining in the sunshine as he gives it short to Isak, scorer of Newcastle's penalty at the edge of the penalty area. They work it again out wide on that right-hand side. Emil Kraft is there, and it's back to Cher on halfway. And now Byrne, and Newcastle will try and find a different route, because that right-hand side was completely closed down by West Ham United. So instead they're going to probe to the left, but they're going to try the right once more, because Kudus maybe has just taken his eye off the ball. Emil Kraft with a cross towards the back post. Gordon, brilliant takedown, but Sufal gets in the way, and it's out of play. What will be a goal kick to West Ham United.
Yeah, and as soon as they lose the ball, West Ham, they're so well drilled in the way that they just get back into shape, sit deep, try and frustrate. They don't mind crosses, that's for sure. Mavropanos and Zouma are excellent in the air to deal with crosses, and then they'll look to break when they can.
Half an hour played at St James's Park. It's Game Day Exclusive on Talk Sport. It's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 1. Don't forget, we've got you covered as we enter the running in this enthralling Premier League season. The title race, European places, and of course relegation, all still to be decided. And we'll bring you the key games every step of the way until May. Two more of them coming for you later today, of course, and then in midweek, every single Premier League fixture is available via the Talksport network. That's Talksport, Talksport 2, or via the Talksport app. If you don't have it yet, get downloading now, and you'll be able to find the list of commentaries there. And we'll have every midweek game, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, covered for you on the Talksport network. There's a foul on Alexander Isak just inside the West Ham United half, and it's taken short by Newcastle this time as they look to come forward again into the last 13 and a half minutes of the first half. Here's Willock down this left-hand side, just about keeps the ball in play on the charge. Socek back pedalling, and he's still going, Willock. He's got Gordon there with him on his right foot. Now goes down the line, but again, it was too far ahead of Willock and out of play for a goal kick. And it almost feels like West Ham have kind of ridden out that early threat that was coming from Newcastle. There's just a little bit of frustration that things aren't quite clicking for the Magpies.
Yeah, and when those sort of things happen where you go to pass and the player stops, you know, that breeds frustration within the support when they see attacks break down with such ease. But Newcastle seem to have just got to grips with the tempo since the changes and started to have a decent amount of possession.
Pakatar on that far side, the challenge coming in from Guimaraes. He's gone down again, Pakatar, but once more Rob Jones not interested. Anthony Gordon for Newcastle United. West Ham are down to 10 at the moment because Pakatar is still down on the floor. Kudus tries to get round Kraft on that far side, but they're going to have to put the ball out because Pakatar is still down on that far touchline. Once again, the challenge from Brunei Guimaraes, his Brazilian teammate for his national side. But again, Rob Jones not interested, Dean.
Not at all, no. He just tried to move his feet. Pakatar has made a lot of it. And that's the problem. When you do make a lot of a challenge, you don't tend to get the free kick. I'm sure there was contact, but when you throw yourself to the floor in the way that Pakatar did, you're less likely to get the decision.
You're listening to Newcastle versus West Ham on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Whatever the mission, home or away, Enterprise helps over 120,000 people every day. We're into the last 12 minutes. There will be plenty, I think, of time added on at the end of this first half. Probably at least 5 or 6 minutes, you would have thought. We had a two-minute VAR check on the penalty, and then the injury to Jamel Lascelles and the current treatment that Lucas Pakatar is having on that far side. On Pakatar, West Ham haven't won a game without him in the side. Have you ever, you and I were together at Nottingham Forest where they looked, you know, there was no life in them at all off the back of that defeat against Arsenal. As soon as he came back into the team against Brentford, it just gave them, have you ever known a player who has that much of an impact, that one player returning almost transforms the entire 11?
I think in the way that West Ham play, the difference is just so unique because they do sit deep, because they look to counter-attack, and he is the player that links it. Without him, the other players that step in don't have his quality, his vision, as we saw with the goal. That link between sitting deep and counter-attacking with speed needs the key to unlock it, and that's what he is. And without them, you just sat there with a closed door.
Yeah, that's the problem. A defensive side who can't have that power to counter-attack, as you say. Long one forward here for Mavropanos.
He's made a difference, though, Antonio, hasn't he, since coming back from injury? He always does.
Certainly offers that physical presence, doesn't he? I mean, Bowen has scored 14 goals, having spent most of the season playing as that front man. But Antonio's presence, and we know David Moyes loves him, doesn't he? There's no doubt about that. That's why no one ever, whether you're talking some of the replacements they've tried to sign, it's never really worked out for it. Generally because Antonio's still there, isn't it?
Yeah, he embarrasses them out of the team because most players can't work in the way that he does. The shift that he put in, already shown his quality to.
Fought to so far, but given away. Willock finds Isak 35, 40 yards out from goal. Isak still a ball at feet here, moving into a more central position. Bit of space there for Longstaff, and now for Murphy on the right-hand edge of the penalty area. Murphy gets the ball across, headed down, and just wide by Anthony Gordon, who was arriving at the edge of the six-yard box, nodded it down into the ground, but it's inches wide of Areola's left-hand upright, and not a single challenge from a defender.
Yeah. Alan Shearer, this was not, by the way. This is a magnificent chance. Murphy with a delightful ball in. Bang! bang on the penalty spot. Gordon makes a great run across, so foul. It's a free header, and he just gets his angles wrong. He puts it 3 foot wide of the right-hand post, but he was completely free. The height of the cross was perfect. He's got to do much, much better.
Still one apiece as the noise rises again inside St James's Park. And, well, it won't surprise you to hear that Lucas Paquetar is on the floor again. This time he's joined by a Newcastle player as well. And I think it's Bruno Guimarães once more.
No surprise there either.
Two of them flat out. I think they're going to be all right. It's probably just a winding moment, I think, more than anything.
Yeah, to be honest, at first glance, I felt as if Bruno Guimarães had gone in with the elbow and just caught Paquetar early. I mean, Guimarães, as some players do, just pretending that they're hurt just to take the attention away.
Well, it was
a good battle, that little push from Paquetar into the back of Guimarães, but then seems friendly enough.
Well, he's walking that tightrope with those 9 yellow cards, Guimarães. He's done it for the last 7 games. He's got to get to match 32 without picking up a 10th booking, or he'll find himself banned for 2 games, which is why Edson Álvarez is not in this West Ham United starting lineup today. Here's Ward-Prowse to deliver this free kick into the penalty area. Socek was trying to get there. It comes down to Zouma at the edge of the penalty area. Bowen gets the shot away, and Dubravka goes down and makes the save inside his 6-yard area. Quite comfortable in the end, but there was a moment there for West Ham.
Yeah, there was. Just watch Bowen. He was nice and alive. He was on his toes, waiting for the knockdown.
Isak slides in Gordon down the left-hand side, edge of the penalty area, cutting inside on his right foot, goes to bend one to the far post, but never enough bend on it, and it took a deflection of Sofal, so it's going to be a corner for Newcastle United.
Yeah, he's got the beating of Sofal, hasn't he, Anthony Gordon, pace-wise, trickery. I think he just needs to work on just a couple more options. It's so obvious in the way he comes onto that right foot and looks for the far corner. Areola's already looking for it, the defenders are waiting for it. Can he maybe just add that couple more, maybe checking onto the left, maybe whipping it into the near post?
Here's the corner for Newcastle then, on that right-hand side, taken short by Gordon. It's going to come all the way out here to Murphy, who's now going to load it into the penalty area from a much better angle. Areola punches, gets some distance as well, up towards Bowen, and Murphy will just have to try and keep it alive, and he does. He punts it back in to the left-back position for West Ham, where Emerson will just let it run out of play, and it will be a goal kick for West Ham away to our left-hand side. A reminder, in April we bring you over 50 commentaries across the TalkSport network. The conclusion to the EFL, the latter stages of European competitions, of course, the WSL, the FA Cup, and of course the Premier League as well. You need go nowhere else, as the end of the football season is in sight. We're into that final stretch, and we've got you covered across the TalkSport network. Long punt forward from Areola. Kudus goes up to try and win the header. Oh, and there's a clash there, and it's Souček, and it's a coming together. It's completely accidental between him and Guimarães, I think, again. Nothing really either could do about that, but it is going to be a yellow card for Souček. I thought they kind of crashed into each other, but Rob Jones sees it the other way.
Clever, though, Guimarães. Just lovely, quick thinking. Little flick round the corner. Souček just steps across, I think. Knows that he doesn't want to get beaten in that midfield area. And just steps across. Guimarães.
Fairly solid individual, Souček, as well. Not one you want to be crashing into. Guimarães. It's a yellow card, by the way, for Souček. Guimarães with the free kick for Newcastle from just inside the Magpies' half. And it's headed away by Mavropanos. Attempted clearance from Kudus on that far side. Emerson will just lift it forward, and Antonio is going to try and get there first with a flick on, which he does. Finds Kudus, who's then tripped, was he? No. Rob Jones says he went down of his own accord, and no contact from Cher. And now a chance for Gordon, maybe down this left-hand side, but the pass, oh, it's headed down by Sofal into his own penalty area. Gordon looked like he was going to get there first, but Mavropanos manages to get his teammate out of trouble, and the ball's just punted into touch on this near side.
Yeah, again, maybe just showing the pressure that Sofal's under from Anthony Gordon. Just heading it almost anywhere. Lucky his centre-back came across Mavropanos with a clever header.
1-1 at St James's Park. You're listening to Talk Sport. Just under an hour from now, we'll bring you the team news for the 5:00 kickoffs this afternoon, of course. One of those being Tottenham against Luton, which is our next live and exclusive commentary at 3 this afternoon. In the meantime, Gordon down this left-hand side for Newcastle United. Again, feeds a ball into the penalty area, but at the edge of the six-yard box, Mavropanos will get it clear up towards Antonio on this right-hand side, who managed to control it, but just spins it out of play, and it will be a throw for Newcastle United.
But that's what he gives you. He gives you the option that if you are under pressure, you can just spin that in behind, and he'll try and get hold of it. It's good strength from Dan Byrne, just to put a bit of pressure on the touch from Antonio.
Good battle that between those two, isn't it?
Heavyweight battle.
Here's Guimaraes from deep inside his own half. Isak inside the centre circle, feeds it out to the right hand side, where he finds Graft, and forward they go again. But again, it's another poor pass, and you can hear the fury around us as it goes out of play for a goal kick.
Yeah, you can hear that as a player as well. You can feel that on your back as you've made the pass and your teammates stopped. But it does, it just kind of saps the energy a little bit out of the home support, knocks a little bit of confidence to the Newcastle players.
When you think they've taken 14 points from the last 14 games, Newcastle United, and they've actually in that period conceded 34 goals. They conceded 33 in the whole of last season. And talking to some Newcastle supporters last night, it's very much, they just blame the injuries. They are solely behind the injuries. They've no issue with Eddie Howe in any way, shape or form. Yeah. But it's purely the injuries.
Yeah. I mean, three supporters just on the way in when I was chatting to them about the game said Joe Linton's the biggest miss. He has been such a miss from him in terms of physically and what he does in that midfield area.
I'll probably miss Callum Wilson today because he scored 12 in 14 against West Ham. So I don't think West Ham was sad to see him not available today.
Lovely little quotes in the programme from Callum Wilson just saying, I'm pretty sure the West Ham fans will be glad not to see me.
Here's Willock, lovely takedown on this left-hand side inside the penalty area, slips it to Gordon, and across comes Mavropanos and does some good defending, but just gives it to Livramento. Livramento then finds Guimaraes inside the penalty area, trying to spin and get the shot away that time. It's Guimaraes still going. The challenge from Socek. He goes down. Does Guimaraes, nothing doing, out of play on this near side for a West Ham throw.
It's what they do so well, though, when you watch West Ham, is as you get in and around the penalty area, the West Ham defenders come across, always looking to block.
Throw taken by Sofau. Antonio is fouled, this time inside the centre circle. It'll be a free kick for West Ham United. I think that was a combo then of Dan Byrne and Longstaff taking Antonio down. It was probably the pair of them that were needed in that instance. It looks like we're going to have 8 minutes added at the end of this. Oh, 10 minutes look like they're going to be added at the end of this half. We've got about a minute of normal time to go in this first half. Looking at 10 minutes to be added on. Plenty of delays. It remains one apiece. You're listening to Talksport. Here's Paquetá through to Bowen, onto Kudus, back towards Bowen again, but intercepted by Gordon. The triangle not quite working out on that occasion for West Ham. Livramento does well to get past Paquetá, and then the ball's clipped down for Livramento to try and chase onto. He certainly had the beating of Sofau, but Mavropanos came across and was able to clear once more.
Yeah, I mean, he's quick, Livramento, but he's not that quick. And again, good covering from Mavropanos.
Murphy delivers a ball in, and it's cut away by Mavropanos with a high boot at the edge of the six-yard box. And it needed to be as well, because Isak and Willock were both arriving in the penalty area. Up the other end, here's Antonio, finds Paquetá, clips it towards Kudus down that left-hand side. Mo Kudus inside the penalty area on that far side, gets towards the byline, looks to cut it back, and he does cut it back. No one's there apart from Paquetá. It's Paquetá inside the penalty area, just tries to feed a ball through to Socek, who'd made the run, but in the end it's well defended that time by Guimaraes, who attracts Socek all the way. And Newcastle will try and break clear. Guimaraes again. Gordon wants it inside. He finds Gordon. Then he helps on his way inside the centre circle. Isak's there. We're into the 10 minutes of added time at the end of this first half. Isak out wide to that right-hand side. Murphy. He's going to try and take on Emerson. Is he? No, he lays the ball through, and it's just driven by the overlapping Longstaff and straight into the arms of Adeola.
By the way, let's go back to that clearance from Mavropanos. Ball in from Murphy again. Looks for all the world that Isak's just going to get his head on it. Mavropanos just flicks a left foot out back towards the penalty area to flick it away. It was brilliant And then Kudus again, just a poor ball once he got wide.
Pakatala's down, the referee this time, it's Gordon's down, Pakatala's down, they were both down. The referee Rob Jones is coming over. Socek is deep in conversation with Rob Jones on this occasion. It's going to be a free kick for Newcastle. And Anthony Gordon is looking in some discomfort.
Yeah, he
his
is.
Left leg.
I think it's unfortunate, this one, because I think Pakatala just slips. I don't think he actually makes a challenge. He just quick direction change from Anthony Gordon. And then Pakatala slips and crashes into the ankle of Gordon.
Going to be a free kick, hence why no card was shown by referee Rob Jones. We've had 2 minutes of the 10 added at the end of this first half. Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 1. You're listening to TalkSport. It's game day exclusive in the sunshine at St James's Park. And it's Gordon who's over this with his right foot. Murphy potentially to deliver with the left. And he's going to leave it for Gordon, right-footed. Swinger towards the edge of that six-yard box, and it just evades everybody and spins out of play for a goal kick to West Ham.
Ah, it's a decent ball from Anthony Gordon. Ends up bouncing pretty much on the six-yard line and then bouncing behind. He can certainly ask the question why one of his teammates wasn't there. But this half has felt like it's gone the way you would expect, with Newcastle having more of the possession and creating some chances, but West Ham being a real threat on the break.
With the focus in the Premier League today on the race for European places, the top four and of course the bottom of the table tomorrow afternoon, the top three are all in action, and we've got it covered on the Sunday session. Adrian Durham with Mickey Gray and Perry Groves, the show coming to you live from the Etihad for Manchester City against Arsenal. That's tomorrow afternoon on TalkSport. Of course Liverpool playing Brighton as well, so Adrian in for Sam tomorrow from 1:30. Edge of the penalty area, the shot is taken on and just driven into the arms of Areola, who makes a comfortable save. Areola didn't take that last goal kick. I don't know if he's got a little bit of discomfort.
I just noticed a little bit of discontent between the home supporters when Newcastle just slowed that attack down.
Areola's thrown that one out rather than kicking it, which may indicate that he does have a problem. There are, of course, 7 minutes left of this 10 minutes added at the end of the first half, and maybe he's just trying to get through. Lukasz Fabianski, of course, is the substitute keeper for West Ham United. Here's Anthony Gordon down this left-hand side. Slips a ball into the penalty area. Socek had followed the run that was being made by Isak all the way, and then wins West Ham United the throw with some decent defending. He's had to take on the Alvarez role today, hasn't he?
Yeah. I mean, look, he's willing to do that. I think him and Ward-Prowse are willing to do what's required in terms of defensively being in shape. The work rate that they get through is never ever questioned.
49 minutes on the clock, another six to play. Pakatala just goes past Guimaraes, slips the ball through towards Bowen. The rebound comes to Pakatala once more, who's clattered then by Longstaff, and then he goes down under the challenge from Guimaraes, and the referee says play on. And the roars start because there's a counter on here with Gordon down the left-hand side. He's got Isak in the middle. Gordon cutting in on his right foot, takes the shot, easily blocked. Comes to Guimaraes at the edge of the penalty area. Gives it to Murphy, right-hand side. Murphy back to Guimaraes, who tries to place one. Oh, and he's hit the crossbar. Headed away by Socek, edge of the penalty area. And Guimaraes may well try again. Pakatar comes through with a challenge, throws himself on the floor, and now Kudus, ball at feet. Kudus has skipped past two. Now can he get past Byrne? Yes, he can. Mo Kudus, oh, is he taken down? The referee says no. Edge of the penalty area, shoulder to shoulder. Kudus has to get up, and Newcastle will try and counter.
Big call from the referee, Rob Jones. Was it shoulder to shoulder or was it Byrne? Just stepping right across. Mohamed Kudus, was he going to get to the ball the other side? And what an effort from Guimaraes, by the way, off the crossbar only seconds before. Magnificent curling effort right off the right-hand side of the crossbar.
What a game of football this is. Murphy lays that into Longstaff. Longstaff across the edge of the penalty area. Cleared away. Shares bringing it on. Shares thinking about shooting. Was he? No, he wanted to play the 1-2 with Longstaff. Here's Paquetá. Paquetá steps away. Murphy with a challenge. Referee says play on. Antonio spins it round to Bowen on this right-hand side. Bowen on the charge, deep in Newcastle territory. Bowen down this right-hand touchline. Towards the byline he goes. Good challenge from Livramento. And out for a corner to West Ham United.
Oh, terrific football all round from both sides. Properly going at it. Murphy is surely going to get booked. No.
And I think that's what Thomas Soucek is saying. Hang on a minute. If we've had David Moyes is furious with Darren Bond down below, the fourth official for today. He wants the foul as well on Kudus at the edge of the penalty area. Taken short. Ward-Prowse swings it towards the back post. Soucek nods it on and nodded over the top of the bar by Lucas Paquetá. And it will be a goal kick for Newcastle away to our right-hand side. Oh, David Moyes is livid about that challenge.
He is fuming because it's the most obvious foul from Murphy on Paquetá on the break. And of course the referees allowed the play to go on. But surely you've got to then come back and book Murphy for the challenge. And a big call. I personally think it was shoulder to shoulder with Byrne and Kudus. It's just that Byrne is much stronger and just sent him flying.
Well, I thought we were going to get a replay of Kudus' goal against Freiburg. He had run from deep inside his own half once more. We've had 7 of the 10 added. I'm not sure any of us want this half to end, though, do we?
It's been terrific, hasn't it?
What a terrific game of football. The Premier League well and truly back from its international break. And you're hearing it all live on Talksport. It's game day exclusive. Reminder, Tottenham against Luton coming up at 3 this afternoon, and tonight Brentford against Manchester United. 3 exclusive Premier League commentaries on TalkSport throughout today. If you're doing your last bit of Easter egg shopping or whatever it is you're after, maybe the kids want a little rabbit for Easter. We did that once before, never a good idea. I would suggest you take the app with you, because we're going to keep you entertained throughout the afternoon. And if the drama is anything like it's been in the first 52 minutes here, you are not going to want to miss a moment. Kudus down that left-hand side for West Ham. Bowen's inside the box. Kudus then with a poor ball. He's given it away right to the feet of Guimaraes again, who's been excellent in this first half for Newcastle United. Murphy on that far side, hounded all the way that time by Ward-Prowse, and then by the challenge of Antonio. Now Longstaff. On they go towards Isak on halfway. Gordon's making a diagonal run towards the edge of the penalty area. So Fally's there this time and has the time to now bring it clear for West Ham United. Clips the ball towards Bowen. Livramento's there, but he'll put it straight into touch, and it's a throw for West Ham. We've only had 8.5 of the 10 added. We've still got another 90 seconds to go in this first half here at St James's Park. It's 1-1.
Yeah, better though from Sofa. A little bit more intelligence there, that as soon as that ball was won by Newcastle, he just took 3 steps backwards just to give him the space to make sure that Anthony Gordon wasn't going to get in behind.
Share with a foul on Kudus midway inside the Newcastle United half. Oh, it's taken quickly. Bowen inside the penalty area on this right-hand side, looking to cut onto his left, and Kudus has scored for West Ham United in stoppage time at the end of the first half. A quickly taken free kick. The Newcastle players are furious, but it's Bowen into Kudus who's drilled that high into the top right-hand corner from around 12 yards out, after the referee allowed the free kick to be taken quickly, with Fabian Scher down on the floor, injured. We've had 9 minutes of stoppage time at the end of this first half. You can hear the boos. It's controversial, but it's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 2.
Oh, it's very controversial, especially with it being a head injury as well for Fabian Scher. He's got his hands on his face at the moment, still on the floor. He felt he was caught by Kudus in the face. Rob Jones then allowed the quick free kick to be taken. Paquetá, how clever is he? How sharp is he? How intelligent is he? Into Bowen. Bowen checks onto his left foot, actually takes a touch for himself, takes a big touch into Kudus's path. Right foot, curling away from Dubravka. Dubravka gets a touch, but the power's too much. Kisses off the top of the bar and into the net.
It's the first Premier League goal in 11 for Mohamed Kudus. It's his 7th Premier League goal of the season. What a finish it was too. And it was the foul on Kudus initially from Scher, where Scher went down. But referee Rob Jones, well, he's made some big calls in this first half. There's no doubt about it. We're over the 10 minutes that have been added initially. at the end. I mean, we might get finished before the time Tottenham and Luton start at 3 this afternoon, but who knows if the second half is anything like the opening 45 minutes here.
Yeah, well, ultimately, Rob Jones has decided that Fabian Schär isn't really hurt and that he should have just got up. That's a big call from a referee when it's a head injury, isn't it?
Yeah.
I personally think he's right, because I don't think Fabian Schär is particularly hurt. But ultimately, Newcastle will say, well, hang on a minute, there's a head injury and our centre-back isn't in position because he's on the floor.
Great finish, though.
Brilliant finish from Kudus. Absolutely fantastic. Stole it off the foot of Bowen, who probably wanted it for himself, but just made sure with the power and the curl to get past Dubravka.
Newcastle get us back underway. They trail by 2-1, having led here as early as the 5th minute of this game from the Isak penalty. Here they come looking for an equaliser before half time, but across goes Emerson with a sliding challenge and he beats Murphy to the ball, and they're not happy on that far side, the home supporters. I think they felt Murphy could perhaps have come to the ball on that occasion. We've had nearly, what, 12 minutes added on at the end of this first half, almost up to 57. Here come Newcastle again down that right hand side. Emerson's there as the first chorus of I'm Forever Blowing Bubbles rings out from the West Ham supporters high in the top of the stand away to our left hand side. And at that point, you can tell by the boos, Rob Jones blows the half time whistle. And what a 57 minutes of football it turned out to be. Anthony Gordon fouled early on by Sofal, Isak converting the penalty, the equalising goal coming for West Ham United, and it was a decent goal as well. Terrific finish, which from Mikel Antonio on one-on-one against Dubravka, his fourth Premier League goal of the season. And then Kudus in stoppage time makes it 2-1. There was woodwork hit by Gimenez, plenty of controversy as well, and plenty for Dean and Resch to pick over at half time. Half time here then at St James's Park. It's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 2.
Adam Rich, thank you very much. Wow, what a breathless score in 57 minutes or so of football we have just seen. Talk about coming back with a bang. Exactly what we've seen out on the pitch today. What a game, Dean Ashton.
Oh, terrific, because Newcastle will always give you that energy here at St James's Park. But West Ham have been absolutely outstanding on the break. And with that front four, they will cause any team problems. And Newcastle, with another injury to their back line, have looked vulnerable so often when West Ham have won the ball back. Paquetá's been involved so often, been so creative, and they've got that pace and quality at the top end of the pitch. But as always, we're talking about the referee. Rob Jones has had so much to deal with in that first half, with players going down like Paquetá, like Fabian Schär, that clearly aren't particularly hurt, and he's having to make big decisions in the midst of all of that. Not very easy. Supporters aren't happy here with him.
Supporters really aren't happy at all. And you know, and the scoreline reflects that as well, of course, because it is West Ham who've taken the lead. And is that scoreline reflective of what we've seen on the pitch, do you think?
No, I think it's been very even, because if you look back at a couple of opportunities that Newcastle have had, Guimaraes hits the crossbar, Anthony Gordon's had a free header from about 7 yards out and should score. I think it's been very, very even. It's what's made it so enjoyable to watch, is because Newcastle have their attacks and then all of a sudden, you know, West Ham will go on their counter-attack and vice versa. It's made for a great entertainment, but probably Eddie Howe will feel very, very... he'll feel disappointed that they're coming in behind, I think.
Well, something else that will disappoint him is, of course, is, you know, you mentioned it, the injury to Jamal Lascelles. Newcastle have made 9 first-half substitutions in the Premier League, more than any other side. That was a few moments in. So unlucky with injuries. And, you know, as a manager, Eddie Howe will try not to kind of focus on that, but it's impossible not to almost, because, as you say, that change in the back line made them more vulnerable to that potent attacking threat that West Ham have.
Yeah, I mean, they conceded very quickly, didn't they, after having to make that change, because it is difficult. I think it's one of the most difficult areas of the pitch to be able to change and get right straight away, which was obvious with the goal, just a miscommunication, and Antonio gets straight through the middle of the pitch. It's really unfortunate, but Anthony Gordon, I thought, summed it up perfectly. We're not going to play the victim. We've got to get on with it. We've got, you know, That's why you have deep squads now, is to bring players in, you know, when they're injured. But of course, you know, Eddie Howe will just feel like, why does this have to keep
happening? Why always me?
To me, yeah, exactly.
Why always me? What's the second half going to hold then, Dean? Because I can't tell you.
No, more of the same, because Newcastle will have to come out. You know, the fans here demand it. And West Ham will just be waiting, ready to pounce as they have done.
Yeah, it's been end to end in this first half at St James's Park. Always a brilliant day out here in the north. It's been absolutely fantastic to watch these two sides go at it. We did say in jest, didn't we, that these two sides are going for seventh in the Premier League table. They really will go at it, won't they, until the end of the season. But here at St James' Park, we've got another 45 minutes and whatever else is added on. Bring it on. That's coming up next.
Game day exclusive on Talksport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Enterprise has vans of all shapes and sizes. So if you've got a plan, we've got a van. We all fantasize about our perfect home, watching the big game cozied up in the snug.
Another 7-0 win!
Balmy summer nights with the kids playing on the lawn.
We're playing real-life football!
But come on, this isn't real. Listen, if you're serious about making your fantasy a reality, find out what your home is worth instantly with a free online valuation estimate. Get real about moving. Get on the market. Most common time to obtain an online quote between 1st of June 2022 and 30th of September 2022 is under 3 minutes. Excludes Northern Ireland.
In sport, what's just as important as the goals, the glory, the roar of the crowd? Yes, it's the halftime break. Time for a breather, a reset, to keep everything on track. In sports betting, Betfair's safer gambling tools help you do that too. Like timeouts, so you take that all-important halftime break. Or deposit limits, to help you keep count. Manage your play at safergambling.betfair.com. Simple ways to stay on top of your game with Betfair.
18+ begambleaware.org.
Don't break your stride. Hurry to Screwfix for unmissable deals on trade essentials. Big paint job on? Buy the Fortress Big Box set for $27.99 and get a half-price extension pole for just $7.47. Patios and driveways in need of a clean? Get the Titan pressure washer for just $59.99. Shop now, on the app, at screwfix.com or in-store. Delivery fees may apply. Prices valid until at least April 1st, subject to availability. See screwfix.com for full T's and C's.
Mwah. When it's lunch o'clock, I just eat the tortilla naked burrito bowl.
Oh, I didn't know you could get those.
There's a lot you don't know, dear.
Well, I know that shirt's not coming back into fashion anytime soon.
Touché.
Get tortilla, Subway, Pret, and more delivered. For lunch and everything else.
Did somebody say Just Eat?
Charges apply. Check available restaurants in your area and opening times on justeat.co.uk for details.
VAR delays today. Heard that rumour about their striker.
Can't wait to see what the pundits make of that booking. Looking forward to the match report on this one.
When it comes to football, never miss a story. Get the best news, opinion, interviews and gossip at thesun.co.uk. For the football lowdown every day, it's thesun.co.uk.
Uno is now available in McDonald's Happy Meal. So let's see who can shout Uno first.
Bring it on.
Yes. Yes. Ooh. No! A wild card. Right. Ah, yes. Back in the game. Yes. Ooh. No! Draw one card. Ah.
Uno. Better luck next time.
Have fun with your Uno cards. Does that one count?
Nope.
Oh. Some fun. Some food. It's all inside this Happy Meal. Until 7th of May from 11 a.m. Includes one pre-selected book or toy. Uno range comprises toys only while stocks last.
Game day exclusive on TalkSport with Now. Stream all the Sky Sports action like Aston Villa versus Wolves live today, contract free with a Now Sports membership. Search Now Sport. 18 plus. Stream via internet. Terms apply.
Feel the passion and the pride of the Premier League.
Oh, it's a stunning goal!
Game day exclusive
on TalkSport.
You are listening to Game Day Exclusive. I'm Rashmin Chowdhury. I'm here at St James's Park. I've been alongside Adam Bridge and Dean Ashton for a brilliant first half of football between Newcastle United and West Ham United. The scoreline at half-time is Newcastle 1, West Ham 2 in the Premier League. There are also two games that kicked off at 12:30 in the WSL. Manchester City currently heading back to the top of the table as they lead away at Liverpool 3-0. Of course, Chelsea in second do have a game in hand, but City desperately trying to win the WSL title for the first time in what feels like eons. And of course, there is another game in the WSL as well, where it is currently Aston Villa 1, Leicester City 1. Both of those are into the second half now. This is Game Day Exclusive, so we're going to continue to look ahead to today's Premier League action with Super 6.
The TalkSport Match Predictor with Super 6. The rollover is back this March. Predict 6 correct scores for the chance to win a whopping £1 million. Get your entries in by 3 p.m. today with Super 6. 18 plus terms and conditions apply.
Now, each week we'll be discussing games that are featured within Super 6. And for those of you that aren't familiar, but we hope you are familiar with Super 6 by now, it is a free-to-play football game where you can win huge jackpots through your own knowledge. Simply predict 6 correct scores to win the jackpot. The Super 6 rollover has now reached its fourth and final round. Would you believe £1 million jackpot is on the line? Throughout the month of March, the Super 6 jackpot has been rolling over. There's been no winner so far. It's now hit the magic £1 million round. Could the winner be you? Listen out for Dean Ashton's predictions to see if he can help you make your decisions this weekend with £1 million on the line. Dean, we're going to run through the final 6 games on the Super 6 list. We're going to start with our exclusive TalkSport commentary match at 3 p.m. today. Tottenham against Luton. Tottenham need to win. Luton need to win for whatever their hopes are for the rest of the season and beyond.
Yeah, very important for both teams. We were there at the return fixture early in the season, and until Basuma's red card, Tottenham could have scored 4 or 5. I think they will today. I think it'll be a game with a lack of centre-backs for Luton that they'll get punished. I've gone for Spurs 5, Luton 1.
Yeah, Luton definitely in with a chance of scoring, given how Ange Postecoglou's side play. Over 950,000 Super 6 players are expecting Tottenham to get a victory over Luton. That's a very big scoreline as well. What about 3 p.m. today? Chelsea hosting Burnley. What's your Super 6 prediction with that one?
I think it's going to be very similar to the game earlier on in the season between the two. I think there's going to be a 3-goal difference, but I'm going 3-0 to Chelsea, just because of their home form has been very good, actually.
Yeah, they're picking up, aren't they, finally? They're on the hunt as well for back-to-back Premier League wins for the first time since December, which would be huge for the Stamford Bridge faithful, who've been booing Mauricio Pochettino in recent weeks. A massive 96% of Super 6 players are confident that Chelsea will pick up all 3 points at home to Burnley today. And finally, 5:30 this evening in the Premier League sees Aston Villa up against Wolves in that Midlands derby. Who are you going for in this one?
I'm going to go for the home team, mainly because Wolves are just lacking that firepower with the injuries that they've got, the top end of the pitch. And so, you know, I watched them against Coventry. They're not the same team without those players, and I think Villa will take advantage with a 2-0 victory.
Well, Aston Villa, of course, looking to stay in the top four this weekend if they can beat Wolves. Well over 700,000 entrants are predicting Unai Emery's men to win against their West Midlands rivals. So that is all thanks to Super 6. And don't forget, Super 6 has set up its very own TalkSport League. You can sign up on the Super 6 website or app using the code TALKS6, that is TALKS6, where you can also win £100 for topping the league every single round. And remember, get those predictions in by 3 p.m. today. There's £1 million on the line, so make sure you do. 18 plus terms and conditions apply.
The TalkSport Match Predictor with Super 6. The rollover is back this March. Predict 6 correct scores for the chance to win a whopping £1 million. Get your entries in by 3 p.m. today with Super 6. 18 plus terms and conditions apply.
Time now for us to hear from the Game Day Live team what they're covering at 3 o'clock in Whatever the Mission with Enterprise Rent-A-Car.
Whatever the Mission on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Home or away, Enterprise helps over 120,000 people every day.
Okay, Adrian Durham is at the City Ground for Game Day Live. Are you at the City Ground or are you at Tottenham Hotspur?
I'm at the City Ground.
You are at the City Ground. Why am I confused myself? Right,
because
so you're
the
presenting
from Spurs
loose.
Yeah.
Right, okay, we've got Alex Crook at Spurs loose.
Are you
for a
okay?
Second, I don't know if I am, actually, Adrian. Maybe I'm not. Questioning too many things. You are at the City Ground. Big afternoon of you are. That's exactly where you are. Big afternoon of football coming up, actually, Adrian. The Premier League is back with a bang, as we can see here from our 12:30 match. That'll be plenty to live up to then for the rest of the day.
That game is sensational, and the commentary has been brilliant. So really looking forward to the second half. I hope it doesn't die down. I hope there's going to be even more action. But listen, at 3 o'clock there's 5 3 o'clock kickoffs in the Premier League. I'm at Forest Palace. Forest now without Taiwo Awoniyi for a while, which is going to be a problem for them, their best striker.
Yeah.
But Chris Wood should be fit today, so they have a chance of scoring goals. And they've never lost in the Premier League to Crystal Palace, so this is crucial. They're in the bottom three because of the points deduction. Luton out of it, they're at Spurs. That's our commentary this afternoon on TalkSport. And Luton, bottom of the form table over the last eight games, really need to get something going in quick.
Yeah, and it is such a... We talk about the top of the table, but at the bottom, with the points deductions for Everton and Nottingham Forest as well, how tight is it down there?
Well, can I surprise you? Okay.
Of course you can. If you can, I'll be very grateful. Go on.
Right, Burnley have got 4 points in the last two games. They are 5 points off fourth bottom in the table with nine games left. Is it possible Burnley, who we all thought were down, are they entering a little bit of form to the point where we're thinking, hang on a minute, they might actually survive? Because that's 5 points is nothing.
They blitzed everyone away, didn't they, in the Championship last season? They were well ahead of everyone. There's something in that team, isn't there? Despite, I mean, obviously there have been some changes coming into the Premier League. Can they, Adrian? Would you put your money on it?
A year ago next week, they secured promotion. They won at Middlesbrough, secured promotion. And we all thought, wow, he's got them playing really good football. But it's been a completely different story. There was a lot of player turnover last summer. You're right. There are a lot of lone players didn't stay. Nathan Teller, the big one, went to Bayer Leverkusen. Look what he's doing now. You know, you're going to lose a player like that, you're going to have a few problems, especially going up a division. But I don't think they'll do it. But the fact that we've had these points deductions and Burnley are only 5 points off fourth bottom tells me there's still a lot to play for. They've been in form, but they're without Fofana, who scored a couple of goals recently at Chelsea's parent club. So a tough one for them today.
Ooh, do you know what? It's so unpredictable, this Premier League season. Adrian Durham, thank you very much. Adrian at the City Ground, not at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. He'll be with Game Day Live, of course, following us here on TalkSport at 2:30, keeping you in touch with all the other Premier League kickoffs at 3 o'clock as well. Don't forget, you can tell us where you're going, where you're off to this weekend with whatever the mission with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. You can get in touch on Twitter at TalkSport, or you can text us on 81089.
Whatever the mission on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Home or away, Enterprise helps over 120,000 people every day.
Okay, an update for you in the WSL. It's now Liverpool 0, Manchester City 4. Bunny Shaw scored her second goal of the match as well. City are going to the top of the league. Don't forget, Arsenal versus Chelsea is live tomorrow on TalkSport 2 at 3 p.m. Here, though, at St James's Park, we're about to kick off the second half. I'm going to hand you back to Dean Ashton, but first, Adam Bridge.
Yeah, thank you, Reshmin. A half-time change for West Ham. We kind of saw it coming towards the end of the first half. Lukasz Fabianski makes his third appearance from the bench this season. He has started three Premier League games, but he's very much the second choice keeper now for Premier League action at West Ham. But Alphonse Areola's just stopped kicking the ball towards the end of that first half, and clearly a problem. So Fabianski has been warming up through the half-time, and he is on. I'll run you through the rest of the teams when we get a break in play, but immediately Newcastle attacking the Gallagate end away to our right-hand side are on the attack here. Isak into the penalty area, layoff from Willock, trying to find Isak again, but here's Mo Kudus down this left-hand side, who will get it forward for West Ham United. Antonio's going to chase after this, but Byrne will hook it back to Dubravka away to our left-hand side. Dean, a change of goalkeeper at half-time. It's never the most settling of thing, but they're so used to Lukasz Fabianski, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. Obviously, plays in Europe as well. And what a fantastic thing to have somebody with that experience to be able to bring in as a number two.
Gordon on that far side, just the ball forward towards Willock again, who goes back towards Livramento. It's helped on its way, and Guimaraes tries to find Gordon down that left-hand side. Loose ball picked up by Willock, who's charging inside the penalty area. Lifts it towards the back post, and Emerson's there, who has to head it up and behind and away. There was danger arriving in Murphy at the back of the penalty area, but it'll be a corner for Newcastle United, which they're going to take from the left-hand side.
Terrific slalom move from Willock, just to drift away from Sofal, who committed himself once again in the penalty area. It's a good job he didn't stick a leg out. Willock just then dinking the ball to the back post, but Emerson was there, he was alert, he was ahead of Murphy.
Such intensity in that opening 45 minutes. How will the players pick it up at the start of this second half. Here is Murphy to swing the corner in, right-footed towards the back post. It's Socek's shoulder that gets that one away, and then Kudus tries to break from the edge of the penalty area, an attempt to take him down that time by Scher. Kudus keeps going, keeps the ball in and finds Bowen, who's onside here. Bowen's got Ward-Prowse to his right-hand side. Bowen at the edge of the penalty area, takes the shot, scores for West Ham United, and they lead by 3-1. And it's Jarrod Bowen with his 15th Premier League goal of the season, his 8th on the road away from the London Stadium, and only the second time he's scored in a game in 12. Bowen was excellent for England in midweek, and he's been excellent there for West Ham. It's Newcastle 1, West Ham United 3.
Oh, I've got to say, this is embarrassing defending from Newcastle United. How on earth, from your own corner, can you get caught then with Bowen just running right through the middle of the pitch on his own? Brilliant, brilliant work though from Kudus. So, so good. When the ball fell in his own penalty area, lovely little header away. Then he gets the pace away from Fabian Scher, where a lot of players maybe would have gone down under the challenge. He stayed on his feet. He kept the ball in. He plays a brilliant ball away from Livramento into Bowen's path. And when he gets through, if you can score in a European final 1v1, then the Premier League is nothing. And he just fires it low with his right foot to the side of Dubravka and into the back of the net.
15 Premier League goals for Jarrod Bowen now. Takes him level with John Hartson, who managed 15 for West Ham. The most in a Premier League season for the club was Paolo Di Canio, who managed 16. And that obviously is a target that's very much in Jarrod Bowen's eyes right now. His 15th of the Premier League campaign. And he's just found Soufal on that far side, and he's in possession once more. Now Paquetá on that far side. And work to be done here for Newcastle United. Let's run you through the team quickly. Dubravka is in goal. It's Kraft, it's Scher, and Byrne and Livramento across the back. Longstaff, Guimaraes and Willock in midfield, with Murphy, Isak and Gordon up top for Newcastle United. I'll give you the West Ham team in a moment, but Paquetá has it by the corner flag on that far side in front of their travelling supporters who are high up in that stand. It's Bowen on a charge here into the penalty area, but it takes two to stop him. Guimaraes being one of those and Livramento being the other, and it gives Newcastle a chance to counter, but Socek's there with a challenge 10 yards inside the Newcastle United half. But the black and white stripes have it back again as they drive through the centre circle. Referee says play on. Isak gets it wide on this near side. Kraft is there, slips as he plays the ball in. It allows Ward-Prowse to poke it out, and Kudus now to counter down this left hand side potentially. No, he's closed down immediately by Murphy, who does well. Good tackle back from Kudus, and then Emerson just blasts it against Murphy. It ricochets kindly for Kudus midway inside their own half. Now Antonio tries to slip it beyond Scher, and there's a handball, and it's a free kick to West Ham just inside their own half.
Again, tempo hasn't changed, has it? Absolutely brilliant, because the issue Newcastle have got is they know when West Ham do win the ball how incredibly quick, how incredibly slick they've been on the break, that all of a sudden it's just frantic when West Ham win the ball back. But here at St James's Park, they've not been the team that they were last season, have they? 3 ship by Forest, 2 by Bournemouth, 4 by Luton, and already 3 by West Ham today.
Willock on that far side, edge of the penalty area. There's Gordon, tees it up for Longstaff. Now out to Murphy on this right-hand side. Murphy tries it onto his left foot. Easily blocked that time by Emerson. Comes out again to Guimaraes. And now Antonio just tried to spin it round the corner to Paquetá, who was level with him, but it caught his standing foot. And it allows Newcastle to pick up possession again with Livramento on that far side. In short to Guimaraes. We've had 5 minutes of the second half. You're listening to Game Day Exclusive on Talk Sport, where it's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 3. It's Livramento on that far side. In towards the feet this time of Isak, who just teases and moves, and it's played out wide to this right hand side where Kraft is there again. Murphy goes inside him, immediately closed down by Kudus. Is Murphy helped on its way to Longstaff, now out wide to Kraft again. It's well worked by Newcastle towards the back post, and Lukas Fabianski, since coming on at half time, will make his first gather for West Ham United.
Very difficult, but Emil Kraft certainly hasn't got the quality of Kieran Trippier, has he? Or even maybe Livramento on this right-hand side as the right-back, and it showed there, catching practice for Fabianski.
A huge miss when you consider Trippier 10 assists so far this season for Newcastle United. That's taking a big chunk out of their side. Here is Paquetá on this near side with Kudus to Emerson now on halfway. Emerson back towards Zouma, who's midway inside his own half. He was closed down by Guimarães quickly, but they've worked it out here, West Ham. Paquetá, Emerson, it's nice one-touch football. And then it's Paquetá again who goes down. No foul, says referee Rob Jones again. Paquetá is up and about this time. So check inside the centre circle. Then Bowen back to Mavropanos. I think he spent more time on the floor in this game than anyone else.
He doesn't
else,
like Paquetá. To be tackled, does he, Paquetá?
Well, usually his feet are so quick he's got rid of the ball before they arrive, but not today. And I'm sure Rob Jones must be reaching the point when he's going to think of booking him, because if he's not been caught, then surely it's a dive. And it's happened on three or four occasions. Here's Fabianski.
It's a bit premature for the Olays from the West Ham fans up in the sky.
So foul helps on to Bowen, who's got space down that right-hand side. He's got Antonio ahead of him. Bowen cutting in on his right foot, tries the drive, and it's blocked again, this time by Byrne. And out of play on that far side for a corner to West Ham.
Yeah, he might have to do something here, Eddie Howe. Maybe a slight change, whether that's to bring on a couple of substitutions, or maybe tactically might just have to change things, because at the moment West Ham look as if they're going to go and get a fourth.
I will run through that West Ham team when we get a break in play, but it is breakneck speed. Ward-Prowse takes it short onto Bowen. Bowen delivers it at pace towards the edge of that six-yard box. It's headed away this time, though, by Isak. Picked up, though, by Kudus midway inside the Newcastle half, and he goes all the way back inside his own territory to find Fabianski away to our right-hand side at the edge of the West Ham United penalty area. He's gone long down that right-hand side to pick out Paquetá. Lucas Paquetá with the ball at feet, looking to take on that occasion Livramento, but he just puts the ball out of play. And it's going to be, I think, a free kick to Newcastle on the far side, is it? Livramento has gone down. Rob Jones has gone across.
Not quite sure what happened. It's right over the far side for us, isn't it? It looked as if Paquetá just was a lovely bit of skill. By the way, the touch from Paquetá. Fabianski clears it from his own area all the way out to Paquetá, who just lets the ball just sit delicately on top of his boot and just stand right next to it.
Well, yeah, I was going to say, Paquetá has not touched him. He's gone down having played the ball out of play. And that's going to be a corner to West Ham.
Oh, and I've just seen the replay of what happened there. And Paquetá goes to play the ball into the area just along the floor. Livramento, it hits his right foot, and then sadly he rolls his ankle at the same time. So it could be another issue for Eddie Howe and Newcastle.
Well, Elliot Anderson and Miguel Almiron are preparing to come on for Newcastle anyway. Let me give you that West Ham team while we have this break in play. 9.5 minutes gone in the second half. It's Newcastle 1, West Ham United 3. You're listening to Talksport. The goal, it's Fabianski on at half-time for Areola. Sofal, Mavropanos, Zouma and Emerson across the back for West Ham. Ward-Prowse and Socek in midfield. And it's Bowen, Paquetá and Kudus providing the support to Antonio. Goals for Bowen, Kudus and Antonio in the game for West Ham United. Isak's goal came courtesy of a penalty early on in this game. West Ham have scored 3 without response, and it looks like as well we're going to see a third substitution too. We're going to see Lewis Hall coming on too.
Yeah, well, obviously Almiron and Anderson were just coming on, I think, as the changes that was needed I just talked about. But then obviously because of Livramento now looking like he's rolled his ankle, Lewis Hall has got to come on as well.
We're about 7 minutes or so away from the team news in the 5 Premier League games kicking off at 3 o'clock this afternoon that you'll be following from 3 here on TalkSport today. So those changes about to be made. The first is Livramento and Miguel Almiron is coming on. The worry there for Tino Livramento is that it's a nasty little injury. And the second change will see the departure of Joe Willock. And on for him will come Elliot Anderson. I know Eddie Howe says he wanted to get him some time and give him some opportunities, but take it slowly. And Anderson makes his way on. And Lewis Hall is waiting to enter the fray as well, just down below us.
And they're just checking, is that right?
No, they're taking Kraft off. Yeah, they had held up Willock's number. Well, maybe Willock's coming now as well. Now, Willock has come off too. So, yeah, Kraft has come off.
Poor old Emil Kraft. He was looking across, going, what? What, yep. Me?
And Lewis Hall come on It's always a rough one when the substitute gets substituted, isn't it? Has that ever happened to you doing that?
No, thank you. Oh, never live it down.
Corner to West Ham, then when we get play back underway, that's another delay of about 2 minutes there. We're almost up to 12 minutes on the clock in this second half. Ward-Prowse is over there, as is Bowen. They're going to do one of those short ones again. Ward-Prowse looks to play it in low, but this time it's dealt with as far as Sofal. Sofal gives it short to Bowen. Left-footed, he swings that one in, and it just evades everyone. And out of play, away to our left-hand side for a goal kick to Newcastle United.
Yeah, just trying to get to grips with the reshuffle. So Murphy has gone to right back. And obviously Hall has gone to left back, Elliot Anderson into midfield where Willock was in Almiron over up to this right hand side. He took that well, Emil Kraft, top professional.
You're listening to Newcastle against West Ham on TalkSport with Now. Don't forget that with Now you can stream all the Sky Sports action, like Aston Villa against Wolves and Brentford against Manchester United, live today, contract free with a Now Sports membership. Search Now Sports. Down this right-hand side on the attack is Murphy. Murphy looking to cut infield. Close down by Kudus. It's Guimaraes, 35 yards from goal. Out wide to this right-hand side. Too much on that pass for Miguel Almiron. And it will be a throw to West Ham by the corner flag away to our right-hand side.
I'm afraid we've just seen too much of that from Newcastle today, where they've gone to play a ball and it's just gone straight out of play. Whether that's a miscommunication, whether that's a player just stopping making the run. It just, they haven't had any sort of flow, really. They've created a couple of chances, but no sustained pressure.
We'll see what the substitutes can do. Almiron nodding that one goalwards and had to be cleared away. And a throw for Newcastle on this right-hand side ends up at the feet on that far side, the left-hand side of Lewis Hall. Now it's Guimaraes. Guimaraes right-footed ball over the top. Emerson, he almost went to duck out the way of it. And in the end, he's caught the back of his head and gone out of play for a corner to Newcastle down this right-hand side.
That's exactly what he tried to do. He just tried to fake as if he was going to head it and then took his head away but forgot to remove his back.
Looking to take it court. Jason Tindall is out there at the edge of his technical area. Lengthy discussion. I think it's going to be left for Lewis Hall to deliver with his left foot. Jacob Murphy, the only man staying back. Everyone is back for West Ham United to defend this corner down this right-hand side for Newcastle. Left-footed swung towards the back post. Good header away by Thomas Socek. And it's out as far as Anthony Gordon. He'll give it to Murphy. Murphy's 15 yards inside the West Ham half. Swings it out to this right-hand side. It's a ball that's well taken down by Cher at the edge of the penalty area. Almiron tries to work a chance to shoot towards the edge of the penalty area. Anderson's there trying to work his way into the penalty area. Guimaraes slides it out to this right-hand side. Played across the six-yard box. And Mavropanos, who's already got two own goals this season, slid in and managed to divert it sideways. But now Antonio's given it to Bowen on that far side for West Ham. Bowen will go back to Sofal, and then another player has gone down on that far side, Anthony Gordon this time. But West Ham will play on. He's up and about, thankfully. And Bowen will go down that far touchline where he finds Antonio. Antonio just loses out on this occasion. And now a chance may be for Newcastle to build again. Coming down this right-hand touchline. Picked up by Hall. Good work that time by Longstaff. Hall gets it forward. Here is Longstaff now. Anderson wants it ahead of him, but it's not played quickly. Longstaff keeps it. Anderson now gets it. Gives it out wide to that left-hand side. Here's Gordon on his right foot. Oh, he's dispossessed by Bowen on that occasion. Anderson's there once more. Here's Murphy. Right-footed shot. Drills it low. Blocked by Mavropanos again. Newcastle laying siege to the West Ham United penalty area. Laid off again on this right-hand side by Hall. Guimaraes out wide to that far touchline. Anderson's there. Gordon's just dropped inside. Anderson working onto his right foot, gets the crossing. Ward-Prowse heads it away. Only as far as Guimaraes again. 25 yards from goal. Those black and white shirts just swarming around that West Ham United penalty area. Guimaraes again. He's going to bend this one, and Fabianski will gather it quite comfortably away to his left-hand side.
Yeah, they're happy to sit in West Ham in that sense. Good tempo, though, from Newcastle. Winning the second balls when it does get cleared out. Really good cross earlier from Fabian Scher. And again, he's had a good game, Mavropanos. Time and time again now, he's been in the right position. He's been able to clear.
He's had plenty of stick, hasn't he, from some quarters of the West Ham support. Kudus has done brilliantly. Ridden a couple of challenges. He's got Antonio out wide on this left-hand side. Pakatar's ahead of him. Antonio, though, switches play to the far side, to Bowen, who's in the sunshine here at St James's Park. Down that right-hand side, going towards the corner flag. Bowen just closed down by two, but he has the support of Sofal on that right-hand side. Back inside to Socek. He and Ward-Prowse just exchanged passes, and West Ham comfortable to go back inside their own half. Suma's going to be closed down, though, by Almiron, who was due to play for Paraguay in midweek, but that game, which was due to take place over in Russia, quite sensibly got postponed. So he's not been away on international duty after all, Almiron, and he's on as a second-half sub.
Yeah, just looking across at Anthony Gordon when he went down just moments ago. He's not moving as freely as he was, but we know he's like Iron Man. He just calls a new limb in and then on he goes.
Here he is again in possession on that far side for Newcastle United, desperately trying to find a way back into this game. They trail by 3-1 at home against West Ham United. Anderson on that far side, just teasing, trying to get the better of Bowen. Guimaraes is there, closed down by Ward-Prowse. He's forced out to this right-hand side where Murphy will pick up possession. Into Longstaff, lovely 1-2 with Almiron. Guimaraes picks it up, edge of the penalty area, brings in Gordon on a decent angle, and he's drilled that ball. It's flown up in the air, and Zuma gets the header away. Guimaraes inside the penalty area, tries to get the shot, then Almiron, and then Isak stabs at it with his left foot and stabs it well wide of the right-hand upright. That's out of play for a goal kick to West Ham away to our right-hand side. Now Spurs could go fourth this afternoon. They take on a Luton side who are sitting outside the match day bottom three for the first time in a while. It's our exclusive commentary from three. Here's Alex Crook with the team news.
Well, Mickey van der Ven is back in the Tottenham ranks, but only on the bench. One change for the hosts as Werner comes in for Johnson. Two alterations for Luton. Berry and Townsend are in. Out go Clark and the injured Ogbene.
Chelsea have games in hand on those above them in the race for Europe. Burnley, the visitors to Stamford Bridge today. Ollie Clink is there for Talksport.
Three changes for Chelsea, Adam, from their FA Cup win over Leicester. Raheem Sterling is on the bench. Out come Sanchez and Chalobah as well. In come Petrovic, Badiashile and Enzo Fernandez. Meanwhile, there are two changes for Burnley from their win over Brentford. Taylor and Fofana come out of the side. In come Foster and Amdouni.
Newcastle United on the attack here away to our left-hand side after a West Ham attack petered out courtesy of Kudus, who just ran the ball into touch away to our left, but Newcastle have possession. Anderson has made a difference since coming on that far side, just helping tick things over for Newcastle United. Guimaraes finds Gordon. Gordon cutting infield. Guimaraes again towards the edge of the penalty area. Now it's Gordon once more on his right foot, pings it towards the edge of the six-yard box. Zuma is there and clears away comfortably. Guimaraes now inside the area, left-hand side of the box, ball at feet, trickery, trying to move it quickly, slips it through. That's a decent ball as well to Almiron, and then again it's just poked behind from the edge of the six-yard box. It's Sean Longstaff. Well, what an opportunity. He just passed it out of play.
He just wrong foot, two left feet, just completely wrong from Longstaff. Very similar to Isak's chance only moments ago. Lovely ball across, just cuts it back slightly. Both players should let the ball come across their body and just strike through it. Isak slices his, and Longstaff just goes back where it came from because his feet just weren't sorted out. Two great chances.
Forest are in the bottom three following that points deduction. They're bound to come out fighting today. Crystal Palace are the visitors to the City Ground, and Jeff Peters is there for Talksport.
Well, Sam Johnston is out for Palace due to injury. Dean Henderson replaces him in goal. Elise still missing. Willy Bolly got injured on international duty, so Felipe comes in to the Forest defence. Ola Aina returns, as does Hudson-Odoi, Toffolo and Elanga make way.
Look away now, Newcastle United supporters. Fabian Scher has just pulled up with his left hamstring. West Ham have put the ball out of play, so it'll be Newcastle who will throw the ball back to West Ham United. He has walked onto the field of play again, but he's walking very gingerly. This could be a disaster, and Miguel Almiron is also now telling Eddie Howe and Jason Tindall he has a problem.
He is, just he's flexing his knee. Also Almiron is saying, no, I'm not sure I can carry on. This is ridiculous. Absolutely crazy stuff for Newcastle.
Emerson finds Kudus. Here's Pakatar out wide to Kudus again down this left-hand side. Almiron has gone down. I think they want West Ham to put the ball out. And the fact that they're still playing on, here's Kudus back to Pakatar. But Pakatar is going to put the ball out of play to allow Almiron to get some treatment. I think Cher may want some treatment too. While they do that, let's get the rest of the team news from our 3 o'clock kickoffs in the Premier League today. Everton currently sit 4 points clear of the drop zone despite not winning in 11. They're on the worst run in the Premier League right now. They're at Bournemouth today, as is Ian Abrahams.
And a big week for Everton with a possible points deduction still to come. They make two changes today. Seamus Coleman in for Mikhailichenko and Calvert-Lewin for Beto. As for Bournemouth, four changes. Kirkes for Ouattara, Tavernier for Sinisterra, Justin Kluivert for Alex Scott, and Tyler Adams for Ryan Christie. It's Adams' first start in 385 days. His first start for Bournemouth after injury. It's Bournemouth and Everton here at the Vitality.
Harvey Barnes has replaced Miguel Almiron, so a second substitute has been substituted here at St James's Park today. West Ham get things back underway. Just one win in 12 for the doomed Sheffield United. They face in-form Fulham, and surely red-hot Rodrigo Muniz will fancy his chances against the Blades' defence today. Watching for TalkSport, it's Alan Biggs.
Yeah, Fulham arrive unchanged. Pretty rare for any team at this level. Why wouldn't you, though, after a 3-0 win over Spurs? For Sheffield United, three changes. The return of skipper Anel Ahmed Hodgic. Also, Mason Holgate is back after a three-match ban. And Vinny Souza returns as well. Sheffield United versus Fulham.
And a reminder, Adrian's at the City Ground. He'll be looking after you once we've finished here at St James's Park today as we go around the grounds, plus also bring you exclusive commentary of Tottenham against Luton. Newcastle United on the attack again down this right-hand side. Murphy at the byline, clips that one towards the back post, and it's gone out of play, and it'll be a goal kick for West Ham United. Dean Ashton alongside me, the former West Ham and England striker. I mean, the injury issues and the substitutions. I mean, this Newcastle side are in disarray. They're 3-1 down, and we've had two subs substituted.
Yeah, and you probably just felt as if there were players starting to come back, with Botman back in the team and Anderson back amongst the squad and Harvey Barnes and the like, and all of a sudden, squad has been decimated once again through injuries. Fabian Scher's still stretching that left hamstring as well, but he's carried on as at the moment.
Well, a reminder, of course, they've got a game in midweek. Everton here again. I mean, they looked at these two fixtures and thought, what a great opportunity to get some points on the board. Everton will be the visitors in midweek. A game, of course, you can hear live across the TalkSport network, either via TalkSport, TalkSport 2, or the TalkSport app. Well, I don't know if they're going to have enough players to field. Now, West Ham have got a problem. Dan Byrne has gone up for a challenge in the centre circle. And no surprise that the player on the ground is Lucas Paquetar. There's been a change for West Ham, by the way. Mikel Antonio has gone off and Calvin Phillips has come on. We're 24 minutes into this second half. Again, we had 12 minutes added at the end. Well, 12 minutes played at the end of the first half. Who knows how much time's going to be added at the end of this game?
No, I know, exactly. And if you're a Newcastle player, you've got to try and reset. You've still got to think, if we can just create a few more chances, take one of those and try and lift the crowd and get some energy and some momentum back in the game. It's still not over. West Ham, as they've shown all season, certainly aren't the best defensively.
Well, at the moment, James Ward-Prowse is playing in a centre-forward position for West Ham United. Well, I think Paquetar maybe is going to be the one who drops forward, and Ward-Prowse goes into the number 10 role, with Phillips now sitting alongside Thomas Soucek in the middle of the park for West Ham as they look to defend this 3-1 lead they have. We're into the last 20 minutes. Plus, there will be plenty of time added on here at St James's Park, that's for sure. It's Newcastle United 1, West Ham United 3. You're listening to Game Day Exclusive on TalkSport. Here's Kudus. Lovely turn from him. He's got Emerson outside him on this left-hand side. Kudus, though, I think will try and go alone. And then it's a thumping challenge from Fabian Scher. And the ball's out of play. And it will be a throw to West Ham United on this left-hand side, level with the edge of the penalty area.
Yeah, it's about game management now for West Ham. You know, I know there's a lot of time still left in the game. We've got to try and keep some possession when they can and still be a threat on the break.
Emerson short. Paquetar tries to get it back. It's headed away. Soucek will lift it forward again towards Paquetar down this left-hand side, and the offside flag does go up against Lucas Paquetar. You're listening to Newcastle against West Ham on TalkSport with Super 6. Predict six correct scores from this weekend's action and you could win £1 million without spending a penny. Left-hand side, Newcastle United at the edge of their own penalty area with Dan Byrne, and it's a pass that's just gone straight into touch. I think Bowen tried to get there first to intercept it. Couldn't quite, and it's out of play for a throw on that far side. A quick note about Jared Bowen today. That's his 42nd Premier League goal for West Ham. He's just leapfrogged over Carlton Cole in the all-time Premier League goal scorers for West Ham. Long way to go to catch Antonio on 64, of course. But this is also his 19th in all competitions this season. And the last West Ham player to score more than 20 goals in all competitions in a season was... I know Sam likes to do a quiz, you see, so I just thought
Marlon Harewood.
It was Marlon Harewood. Well done. I would say you can have a chocolate egg for that, but you seem to have eaten most of them already, dear. Well, there's a bit of a caramel left. Look, producer Sal has delivered on the chocolate front today, as has Reshman as well. Look, I feel bad that I didn't bring anything, Dean, don't you?
No, because we're here to eat it.
Oh, that's true. Good point. Newcastle United on the attack down this right-hand side. Anthony Gordon looking to edge towards the edge of the penalty. Well, that's a good ball across the box, and it's a great save from Lukas Fabianski to deny the player arriving at the back stick. It was Elliot Anderson. It was a terrific ball across the edge of the six-yard box. Vladimir so far looked to be sleeping, and the driven shot was brilliantly saved by Fabianski.
Excellent, wasn't it? What a ball from Anthony Gordon, right behind every single West Ham player. I think it's Harvey Barnes, actually, who gets in behind Sofal, who switches off just for a second. And it's a really good save down to his left-hand side from Fabianski, because there's power on it, maybe just too close to the goalkeeper.
You're right, it was Harvey Barnes. Good effort from him. He's not played many games this season, but he's still managed to find the back of the net already twice in only 11 appearances in the Premier League for Newcastle United due to all his injury woes. Shows there's still life in this game yet, potentially. Zouma comes across and hacks that clear from inside the West Ham United penalty area away to our right-hand side. Throw taken quickly, and it's picked up this time by Anderson, who goes back towards Byrne. Byrne will look across to Cher on this right-hand side. Everyone is camped inside the West Ham United half. 17 minutes plus time to be added, which I think there'll be plenty. Here's Gordon at the byline. Clips it towards the back post, and there's a sandwich of players at the far post. Driven goalwards. Fabianski with the save. Attempted shot from Gimenez. No one can turn it home. Trying to spin inside the six-yard area. Appeals for a penalty. Referee waves them all away. And in the end, Soufal will try and clear from that far side. And it's a goal kick to West Ham United. Dean Ashton picked the bones out of that.
Oh, there's just too many bodies. How am I meant to see it? There's about 15 bodies in the space of about 3 square metres. It's incredibly tight in that penalty area. Really good from Harvey Barnes to get the strike away, first of all. Great block from Socek. He's on the floor. He flicks it away. And then Anthony Gordon, very similar to the first half where he gets ahead of Sofal. I think he gets ahead of Calvin Phillips, who looks like he goes to clear it and just clatters through Anthony Gordon. This could easily be a penalty.
Well, I was going to say, Gordon's hooked his foot round, about to play it. Well, Phillips is about to play it, and suddenly Gordon's foot appears, doesn't it? And they are checking, VAR are checking for the possible penalty.
I mean, Phillips knows nothing about it. He doesn't see Anthony Gordon behind him. He is just thinking, I'm just going to clear this. And Anthony Gordon, I'd say pretty bravely, just sticks his leg in the way as he tries to hook the ball, and he knows he's going to get whacked. Takes a clatter from Calvin Phillips, and down goes Gordon. I'd be mightily surprised if this isn't a penalty.
Well, like you say, Phillips knows nothing about it, doesn't he?
And it's identical to the penalty in the first half, where Sofal tries to clear.
Well, Rob Jones is walking out of the penalty, and he is on his way to the VAR monitor over on that far side. Well, we know what comes next. Maybe there's a twist yet in this game. What we do know is it's going to have more time on at the end. We've got 15 minutes plus what must be already 6 or 7 minutes to be added at the end of this game. So plenty of time for the home side. Dean thinks it's a penalty. I've now seen it again. I'm convinced it's a penalty. Resch is nodding as well. Sal for the complete set. Oh, he doesn't know. He's just holding his arms up in the air. Well, Rob Jones is looking at the monitor on that far side. How often do referees come back and go, no, I'm not giving that. I don't suppose he can't have had a clear view anyway.
No,
because the amount of bodies in that box is crazy.
If the first half penalty was given, this is pretty much identical. Anthony Gordon gets there first, sticks his leg in the way. Calvin Phillips just comes through the back of Anthony Gordon's calf. It's just whether the referee feels as if Anthony Gordon's got no interest in playing the ball.
And it's a penalty. It's given by Rob Jones. Newcastle have their second penalty of the game. And Alexander Isak, who scored twice against West Ham in October, will have a chance to score for a second time today. There's plenty of arguments coming. Calvin Phillips, well, I mean, could Calvin Phillips have any more of a nightmare in a West Ham United shirt. David Moyes is absolutely furious down below. Jason Tindall and he talking to fourth official Darren Bond. David Moyes livid with the decision again. He almost looks exasperated by it as well. We had the controversy at the end of the first half when Cher was down on the floor. West Ham took a quick free kick and scored to go 2-1 in front. This time the controversy is was making David Moyes furious. I don't think when he sees it he can have much to argue about. So it'll be Isak this time against Fabianski. He's already beaten Areola once in this game. A chance to get Newcastle back in this on his right foot, and he sends Fabianski the wrong way as well. And it's game on at St James's Park. Isak's got his second of the game, and Newcastle United are back in this. Newcastle 2, West Ham United 3.
And that's what they needed. They needed to lift this place. And that penalty decision has done. But it was all about the mind game between Isak and Fabianski as to would he go the same way or would he change. Fabianski thought he'd change and Isak called his bluff and went exactly the same way. This time it didn't kiss off the post. He just made sure that it went into the back of the net.
Zuma with a long pump forward towards Kudus down this left-hand side. Murphy's there sweeping up. They'll try and bring it out here, Newcastle, but it'll only come as far as Zuma again. Emerson down this left-hand side. Kudus in a tight space, closed down by Murphy and by Gordon, who's lost his footing again. Not for the first time in this game. Zuma swings it out to the far side. So foul is there, and it's out of play for what will be a throw-in on that far side to Newcastle United. Calvin Phillips can't catch a break in a claret and blue shirt, can he?
No, look, I don't blame him particularly for that because, you know, it happened so quickly. Gordon's so quick. He's just trying to quickly clear the ball. He can't pull out of the challenge in the end, but you're right. It just seems to go from bad to worse for him in a West Ham shirt.
Bobby Barnes on that far side, drilling it forward across the back to Isak, who tries to get the shot away, but again it gets caught under his feet. And listen to the roar inside St James's Park. The sun is out, the sky is blue, and they smell blood.
Yeah, they do. Really good run from Lewis Hall down that left-hand side, overlapping Harvey Barnes. Gets himself to the byline, cuts it back, and does really well to get it to Isak. And Isak just tries the little Cruyff flick into the back of the net. And as he does that, the Cruyff flick hits him on his other leg and goes to nothing.
Well, in April, we're bringing you over 50 commentaries across the TalkSport network. The conclusion to the EFL, the latter stages of those European competitions, the FA Cup, WSL, and of course the Premier League as well. And if they're going to be anything like this one, which is the start of the return after the last international break, well, boy, you're in for a roller coaster ride. Make sure you take TalkSport with you wherever you go throughout April. Phillips, Gordon went down. I think there was some attempts to get a free kick, but I don't think Phillips touched him. Kudus has done brilliantly, got the better share, and Anthony Gordon has almost ripped the shirt off Mo Kudus's back, and he's going to get a yellow card for it.
It's probably one of the best yellows he'll take this season. It's not great to see, is it, because he knows exactly what he's trying to do and trying to stop the counter-attack, just drags Kudus back. David Moyes now getting a yellow card himself.
He has, yeah. David Moyes has been told to sit down, which is, I'm sure, something he won't appreciate. Kevin Nolan, of course, who scored 30 goals in his 91 appearances here, is out in the technical area as well. And Rob Jones has just told Kevin Nolan to tell David Moyes to sit down. I think you're a brave man to tell David Moyes what to do, but he's got a yellow card. And are West Ham guilty here of maybe just retreating a little? The Zuma kicks long?
Not really, because it is kind of what they do anyway. But that threat's gone, isn't it? That intensity to go and get a fourth, a fifth, when Newcastle were clearly on the ropes with the injuries and the substitutions, but because they allow the opposition possession, it always gives them a chance to build up a bit of confidence.
You're listening to Newcastle against West Ham on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Whatever the mission, home or away, Enterprise helps over 120,000 people every day. We have 10 minutes plus added time to play at St James's Park. It's game day exclusive on TalkSport, and it's Newcastle United 2, West Ham United 3. Here's Murphy, right for the ball, swung to the edge of the area, or the 6-yard box, and Fabianski will come out and gather quite comfortably for West Ham United.
I mean, you do look at the change, don't you, for Antonio? I know they might be managing his minutes, of course, but that change was a defensive change. You know, you bring on Phillips for a striker. It wasn't like you brought on Ings just to still give you that same shape and a bit of pace up the top end of the pitch.
Well, it's clearly a, we're 3-1 up. I just want to see this
exactly,
game out.
Yeah, let's protect Antonio's minutes perhaps and try and shore things up. It's actually done the opposite.
Well, and the result now is Pakatar's playing wide on the right. Kudus is still on the left. Bowen has now gone into that central position. But Pakatar was having such an influence on the game playing in that central 10 role.
Yeah, but these are the calls you make as a manager. And you'll certainly have to stand by them when he's interviewed afterwards. They've still a long way to go yet in this game, though.
Emerson's ball into the box looking for Socek. Bowen's on the charge to try and win that ball back on the far side. Off of, I think it may have been, or they've just shuffled things around again. Murphy is now playing as the right back, it looks like, for Newcastle United in this desperate attempt to get as many players forward as they can. Lewis Hall there wide on the left hand side. He's got Barnes and Anderson now going through the middle. Here's an opportunity for Harvey Barnes through the legs of Fabianski, and Newcastle United are level, and it's Harvey Barnes back from injury again and back doing what Harvey Barnes does, scoring goals for Newcastle United. It's Newcastle United 3, West Ham United 3.
It's too easy, they've switched off West Ham. Ball into Isak, he can just turn, nobody's near him. He can get his head up, he can pick a pass. The defence don't drop. Nobody tracks the run of Harvey Barnes, he just glides away from so foul. He keeps himself onside, he waits, he's patient for Fabianski to come out. Just keeps it low. Hopes for the best, sometimes that's the best way. Goes right through Fabianski's legs. And wow, we've got a game on.
We have indeed, 3-3, and we have 7 minutes plus added time still to play at St James's Park. Now Ben Johnson's coming on for West Ham United, and he's going to replace James Ward-Prowse, which I think many would feel that's, again, another slightly defensive move from David Moyes, and the score is now 3-3.
Yeah, it is, but it's one you can pretty much put your clock by in recent games. Johnson tends to come on towards the end of games.
Throw in for Newcastle midway inside their own half. Can they go on and win this game? As we said, there's been some remarkable games here this season. The 4-4 against Luton is one that particularly springs to mind, of course. And here we are, we promised you goals. Since the new year, they've averaged 5 a game. Well, they've beat that today, 3-3, with 6 minutes plus added time to come. It's like Harvey Barnes got a yellow card for his celebration as well from referee Rob Jones. Funnily enough, Harvey Barnes scored his first ever Premier League goal against West Ham United back in 2019, when of course he was playing for Leicester City at the time.
I think we could be forgiven for missing a yellow card and all this.
Yeah, I'm not sure that we did. It must have been the celebration, I assume. Here's Isak. Isak towards the edge of the penalty area. He's on a hat-trick as well, remember. Drilled across the edge of the box. And half cleared away up as far as Pakatar, who's caught by Cher with a thumping shoulder into the back. Referee says play on. Pakatar, no surprise, on his knees again. Here's Murphy on this right-hand side. There's a chance for Guimaraes at the edge of the penalty area. Again, he's avoided a yellow card thus far, Bruno Guimaraes. There'll be 8 games in a row he's managed not to get booked, as that's swung across by Murphy. And it's out by Zuma, and it'll be a throw down this right-hand side for Newcastle.
Got the crowd behind them now, haven't they? You can just sense every second ball, their first two at the moment.
Guimaraes into Longstaff, who drills it towards the back post. And arriving on the slide that time may well have been Harvey Barnes, but he couldn't quite get on the end of it.
Well, the energy's gone from this West Ham team. They can't get out to anyone now quick enough. Can't close players down. They're not following the runners. Oh, the Premier League. We've missed you.
Oh, we have. 4.5 minutes plus added time still to go here at St James's Park. I mentioned, of course, Harvey Barnes' former side, Leicester. They're in action on Monday. We've got 4 Championship commentaries for you on Monday. I mean, the excitement in the Premier League, there's excitement in the Championship. Leicester try to get back to winning ways and back to the top of the table when they take on Norwich at lunchtime. That's followed up by Stoke against Huddersfield, Ipswich against Southampton, and Leeds against Hull as well. All part of our 50 games in April
on the TalkSport network. Well, here's Bowen, his dispossessed Longstaff, probably about 30 yards out from goal. But there's no energy in this West Ham United side. Everything is coming from Newcastle United. 3-1 down, they've pulled themselves back to 3-3. 3.5 minutes, plus what must, again, it's going to be somewhere around 10, surely, added on at the end of this game. Here at the edge of the penalty area, down that left-hand side, is Barnes teeing up for Gimenez, who tries the shot. It's blocked. Paquetar on this near side just tries to get away from Cher, whose hamstring is still causing him huge problems. Here's Longstaff, out wide to the right. Murphy, lovely bit of skill, gets the better of Johnson. Johnson then redeems himself, pushes Murphy to the byline. Looks like it maybe had gone out of play, but the assistant on this side says he managed to keep it in. Here's Kudus on the far side, being held, you would feel, on that far side by Isak. And the referee flags that up for offside, and it will be a free kick to West Ham United.
Oh, the tempo from the Newcastle players. I've got to say, actually, the substitutes have made a huge difference, especially down that left-hand side. Lewis Hall and Harvey Barnes and Anderson have given real energy to the team when it looked like they were flat.
You could say the substitutes have made a huge difference to West Ham as well. Yeah. Just not in the positive way they have for Newcastle United.
No, they haven't.
And also worth remembering, some of them were forced. Amorim going off, that's the only reason that Barnes came onto the field, because of Amorim's injury.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And he's been terrific since coming on. But it's just, they've got to be careful, Newcastle, you know, getting forward with the energy. It's where West Ham can be very, very dangerous still.
You went for a draw before we kicked off today, and you might not be wrong, but we shall see. We've got 2 minutes plus added time. You're listening to Game Day Exclusive on TalkSport. Here's Gordon in a central area. Paquetar with a half-hearted challenge. Anthony Gordon just runs away from him and then shoots over the crossbar.
Right, he was just stretching, wasn't he? Lovely little turn. He's got that extra little acceleration of pace to get away from the midfield players. Zuma did well. I thought he just stood his ground, didn't commit himself. Said to Anthony Gordon, well, you've got to beat me in, still get your strike away, and up and over it went.
Well, Darren Bond has just been making signs with his fingers down there. I think it's going to be 8. We'll get official confirmation shortly, but we are into the last 90 seconds of normal time.
Yeah, that's definitely not official.
Fabianski, long clearance. Johnson wins the header. Throw in on this near side for Newcastle United. David Moyes is organising his team. Newcastle have taken the throw so far. Gets the head on to Kudus. Has he got a match winner in him? Here, Mo Kudus. He's on the charge towards the edge of the penalty area. Slips in Bowen, too much on that pass. It means Bowen's had to just check his run. Gets to the byline. Skips between two. Bowen still going here inside the penalty area. Bowen with ball at feet at the byline. And in the end, he just drills the ball behind and out of play with a wild shot. And that will be a goal kick for Newcastle United.
There's your warning, though. There is your warning. All it takes is one little burst away from the likes of Bowen and Kudus, and they can be at your back four. Eventually, Gimenez did well to get across and double up on Bowen.
Into the last 30 seconds, 3-3 at St James's Park. An absolute thriller this Easter Bank holiday weekend. We promised you excitement. It's been an extravaganza of goals so far. Here's Gordon. Zuma's on his tail. Gordon at the edge of the penalty area on that far side. Cuts it back. Shot driven in! Oh, what a goal! It's an absolute stunner from Harvey Barnes. His second of the game. And that will be the winner, surely, for Newcastle United. 8 minutes of added time. But surely, Harvey Barnes has won the game for Newcastle. Absolutely stunning strike with his right foot into the bottom corner. Unstoppable. Fabianski could do nothing about it. And it's Newcastle 4, West Ham United 3.
An absolutely astonishing game to start the Premier League back this Easter. Ridiculous from Newcastle United. They seem down an hour 3-1. You thought there's no way this team are getting anything from this game. They've come roaring back with the help of the support. Brilliant work from Anthony Gordon, first of all. Holds off Zuma. Plays a path into Barnes, who takes it on the back foot. It's such a beautiful touch to start with, just to get out of his feet. And then he rifles it into that far corner with Ben end with pace, with accuracy, past Fabianski. What a stunning goal to possibly win a stunning game.
Eddie Howe has been booked. We are into the 8 minutes added. Harvey Barnes didn't do anything that time, like take his shirt off, which would have been very silly. 4-3 to Newcastle United. Harvey Barnes, 6 goals he's got in his career against West Ham United now. Who needs Callum Wilson when Harvey Barnes can do the job for you? Another bogey player for the boys in claret and blue. Newcastle have the free kick. I mean, I would say I can't hear myself speak. I can't hear myself thinking here. What a noise.
Oh, yeah, when that hit the back of the net, this place absolutely erupted. I mean, they're shell-shocked, West Ham, David Moyes included. To think, from the position they were in, they could lose this game. Madness.
Danny Ings is going to come on for West Ham United. They've won the ball with Ben Johnson, but he then loses out. Socek gets it to Sofal on that right-hand side for West Ham. Maybe they can force something, but they just don't look like it right now. Lovely ball slipped through into the edge of the penalty area. Isak's there, left-hand side. He's beaten to it this time by Mavropanos. Sofal on that far side. And it's out of play for what will be a throw-in to West Ham United by the corner flag. Danny Ings is coming on for West Ham.
I mean, obviously, they want to try and get back into the game. So Fales, who's departing on that far side. Danny Ings coming on. I'm sure there'll be plenty of West Ham fans saying, well, why wasn't Danny Ings coming on when Antonio went off?
So Fal leaves the field of play. And it's Ings will go up front. Ben Johnson will go to right back for West Ham United. What a game. And you're hearing it all live on Game Day Exclusive on TalkSport. A reminder, we've got more live Premier League action this afternoon. Don't go anywhere. Adrian Durham is at the City Ground, but we'll be bringing you commentary on Spurs against Luton with Alex Cook and Perry Groves from 3 o'clock this afternoon. And then at 8 o'clock tonight, Brentford against Manchester United. All those games live and exclusive on TalkSport. And a yellow card to Anthony Gordon, is giving it a yellow to Anthony Gordon. That's his second yellow. He's about to get a red card here, Anthony Gordon, and he's been booked for dissent, and he has been sent off by Rob Jones. He was booked early on in the game for the pull on the shirt of Kudus. He almost ripped Kudus's shirt off his back. You said at the time, Dean, that's a yellow card worth taking, but unfortunately his complaining has got him into trouble, and he's got a second yellow, and Newcastle will finish the game with 10 men.
Oh, it just seems such a ridiculous way to get sent off and to now miss a match because of it. He's been absolutely terrific, Anthony Gordon. Why? Why would you do such a silly thing?
We've had 4 of the 8 added on by Rob Jones. So much in this game to dissect and discuss. Outside of the 7 goals, as it's launched forward by Fabianski. Socek nods it into the box. Ings trying to get in there. He saved West Ham against Burnley, did Danny Ings. I'm wondering if he can get them a point again today, but Emerson's there, and now the counter's on. They've held on to it too long here as it slipped through down that left-hand side for Gimenez. Gimenez in the box, out comes Fabianski, and manages to save the ball at Gimenez's feet and deny the Brazilian a chance.
We've still got 3.5 minimum to go. Honestly.
There's Paquetar. He's fired that from in between the two centre-halves, Lucas Paquetar. Bowen was on the chase. And it's going to be Murphy who gets away down this right-hand side for Newcastle. Here's Isak out wide on this right-hand side. Barnes is arriving. Gimenez is coming. Isak's going to go alone, is he? Isak to the byline. Cuts it back into the arms of Lucas Fabianski again.
Oh, terrific Mavropanos. I really fancied Isak there, 1v1 against Mavropanos. He's got wonderful, dazzling feet as Isak on his hat-trick as well. Mavropanos stuck to it. Stuck to his task there. Brilliant defending.
We're into the 6th of 8 minutes added by referee Rob Jones. The 10 men of Newcastle lead West Ham by 4-3. Launch forward towards the Newcastle penalty area. Dan Byrne is there to head it away with purpose. Throwing on that far side for Calvin Phillips to take. Here's Johnson. Johnson across the back to Mavropanos. Out wide on this left-hand side is Emerson, but he goes to the obvious player. Lucas Paquetar. Paquetar on that far side. Here's Kudus on his left foot. Pings that ball towards the back post. Socek's there. Oh, and it's come off Socek. There was a hand on it from Dubravka, and it went into Socek and then went behind into the side netting.
What a chance this is for Thomas Socek. Kudus with a magnificent ball, and I don't know what Thomas Socek is thinking. Yes, Dubravka throws himself towards the ball, but he chests it. Why isn't he heading this? He's one of the best header of a ball in the Premier League, Thomas Socek. Why is he thinking about chesting it? He chests it into the side netting. Just keep your eye on it. Forget about a flying goalkeeper in front of you and just head that equaliser in. What a chance.
And they're taking their time over this goal kick away to our left-hand side. We've almost had 7 of the 8 minutes added originally by referee Rob Jones. I suspect we'll go beyond that. We played 57 in the first half, remember. And it was in stoppage time then that West Ham went in front in this game. They led by 2-1, then they led 3-1. In the second half, courtesy of Jared Bowen. But since then, Newcastle United, 3 times they've scored without reply. And they lead 4-3. Emerson down that left-hand side. Here's Murphy by the corner flag. Gets some help from Longstaff. And now they'll try and bring it clear. Anderson there as well. Murphy clears, only as far as Zouma, though he lets it run towards Mavropanos. Final 30 seconds, last chance for West Ham. Is there a moment, or was that it for Thomas Socek? Here's Paquetar. Lucas Paquetar just clips it forward, looking to try and find Socek, and there's a foul. It's given for the free kick. Goes Newcastle's way. Dan Byrne, the player, fouled by Thomas Socek. And Jason Tindall asking, well, come on. Well, surely that's it, isn't it? Looks at his watch. Darren Bond, the fourth official in conversation with David Moyes as well. Jacob Murphy's out on his feet here, away to our left-hand side for Newcastle United. The range of emotions that's gone throughout this game, just extraordinary. The fans were turning on the players at one point, and yet look at them now. Launched forward towards the edge of the West Ham United penalty area. Fabianski will gather it. It's now down to referee Rob Jones. Emerson's down and needs some treatment. No, he's going to... No, I think he was going to try and get straight up to allow play to continue. He is up. And Fabianski will have the ball in hand. We are, what, 40 seconds over the 8 minutes added at the end of this game. It remains Newcastle 4, West Ham United 3. Game day exclusive on TalkSport. Paquetar tries to win the header, doesn't win it. And now Guimaraes will try and break on that left-hand side. It's intercepted by Ben Johnson, who's on the charge forward now. Johnson gets past Longstaff. He's got running, but he says, where are you all? And he goes back to Zouma in the centre circle. Here's Phillips. We've had 9 minutes added at the end of this game. Lucas Paquetar on that far side. Paquetar's got Kudus outside him. Fires it in. Taken down by Ings. Tries to get the shot away. Zouma's trying to shoot as well. It comes out to Ben Johnson, left edge of the penalty area. Here's Johnson, pings it in, blocked by Longstaff. Out to Emerson, Emerson off the angle of the box. Now Johnson, final chance to cross, surely, on his right foot. Goes to the byline, Johnson pings it across, headed away. And Isak will gather it at the edge of the penalty area. But it's not cleared from danger, and then it is by Longstaff, who punts it forward. Still no whistle from Rob Jones. We've had almost 10 minutes added on to the end of this game. There was 8 prescribed originally. Johnson wins the header. Here's Paquetar on his left foot, sweeps it to the back post. Socek goes down, wants a penalty. Kudus is there, keeps it alive, and it's half cleared by Byrne. Takes the ricochet and out of play onto that far side, and it'll be a throw for West Ham.
Well, is it just desperate from Thomas Socek? It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter now. There's the final whistle from Robert Jones, the referee, and St James's Park erupts. And so might it. What an afternoon of Premier League action. And you've heard it all live here on TalkSport. An early goal for Newcastle United from Isak. Faked back by Antonio in stoppage time at the end of the first half. It was Kudus who put West Ham 2-1 in front. In the second half, they went 3-1 up, courtesy of Jared Bowen. A raft of injuries for Newcastle. Two substitutes were substituted off, one of those because they'd picked up another injury. And then three unanswered goals for Newcastle United, the last of which from Harvey Barnes. An absolute stunner, worthy of winning any game of football. The only downside for the Toon Army today is Anthony Gordon's second yellow card, one for a foul on Kudus and one for dissent as well. He was sent off, so they finished the game with 10 men. But what a game of football. Two sides who have absolutely put it all on the line after the international break. Boy, the Premier League is back, and boy, is it back in some style. Full-time at St James's Park, Newcastle United 4, West Ham United 3.
Adam Bridge, thank you very much indeed. How on earth do you begin to unpick that game? You could not take your eyes off it, not for a second. And the 21 minutes or so added time that we had just added fuel to it. Even more excitement. You did not want this one to end. It's never a quiet day at St James's Park, but as Adam said, it's as if the sound has gone through the proverbial roof here in the northeast. The fans are loud and proud, and why wouldn't they be? What a game we have just seen here. West Ham precariously in seventh. They are still in seventh place after full time. Newcastle are now up to eighth, 1 point behind, and there are teams that can catch the Hammers. This is Newcastle's day. What a game it's been. David Moyes are shortly after shaking hands with Eddie Howe, and Jason Tindall was straight down the tunnel. He did not waste a second. Many of the West Ham players who have now gone off the pitch were lying on the pitch in despair. How on earth did they let this game get away from them against a Newcastle side who, of course, are strong at home but have so many injury worries? Two substitutes substituted, and yet they were able to get a result like that. Wow, what a full-time result for Newcastle United. The players are now walking the perimeter of the pitch, thanking all their fans, many of whom have still remained to greet them and to thank their players. Absolutely breathless game. What entertainment in the Premier League. Dean Ashton, what have we just seen?
Honestly, this league, it is just magnificent. Honestly, you just think, this, you know, the game's done. 3-1, West Ham look comfortable. You know, there's Newcastle players dropping like flies. Honestly, and then to be able to muster the character, the energy from, you know, makeshift subs at times and a makeshift back four for Newcastle, I think says everything about what Eddie Howe has built, you know, and the connection between the players and the supporters. You could feel it after that first goal to get them back into it in the second half. You could just sense it between players, fans, staff. There's something special here when that happens, and it's very, very difficult to stop. But I'm sure David Moyes will have to answer questions again about maybe substitutions, the timing of those, and the fact that they can't seem to wilt when the pressure came. But let's just sit back and enjoy what was a magnificent game of football. Absolutely. And why we absolutely love this sport.
Absolutely. If you see Eddie Howe and Jason Tindall with their team now, they're just walking off the pitch, waving, clapping, blowing kisses to the supporters. They're only just done, and they're only just heading off the pitch now. What a game for them. What, you mentioned the substitutions, because it's, as Adam said in commentary, West Ham substitutions made them weaker. Newcastle substitutions made them stronger. None more important than Harvey Barnes.
Honestly, well, we know he's a top-class player. You know, when they signed him from Leicester, you thought, what a good signing this could be. Really unfortunate for him and the club that he's had the injuries that he's had. But when fit, this is a top, top-level elite player. And he showed it straight away. You know, he had a couple of chances even before he scored. And then to score the winner the way he did, taking it on the back foot and then whipping it into the far corner. They've got a great player there. Can they keep him fit? If they can, terrific.
Yeah, absolutely. What an impact he made with those two goals. Anthony Gordon was a player who has made a huge impact here as well, young player as well, sent off for dissent for a second yellow card. What about the penalty incident that kind of put Newcastle back into it? Because at 3-1 to West Ham, you thought, as you said, that Newcastle were down and out. There was that moment, Calvin Phillips came on as a substitute, and he was the man deemed to have fouled Anthony Gordon. He was in possession of the ball at that time. There, you could argue that Anthony Gordon knew exactly what he was doing, almost putting himself in exactly the position where Calvin Phillips was about to kick. Big cue from Anthony Gordon. Should it have been a penalty?
It was the same in the first half. Exactly the same scenario where he knows all he's got to do is get his leg ahead of the defender. And the defender has gone to clear it, as they both did, Sofal and Phillips. And as long as your leg is there, they're going to kick through your leg. Yeah, it's going to be painful, and you've got to accept that. But you know, especially in this age of VAR, when they roll that back, it's going to look like a penalty. It's going to look like your leg's got there first, and they've just clattered through the back of you. So clever, yes. Brave also. Quick, because he's got the pace to get there. But, you know, they needed that. They needed that at that moment, that penalty incident, to get them back.
Yeah, they needed that, didn't they? And, of course, he did get the second yellow card. And he will now miss the next match. Just very quickly on West Ham, though, because, I mean, you know, so many fans don't like the way West Ham play. At 3-1, it was all looking great. But how much of the blame will David Moyes now take for that defeat? And do the fans who dislike his style of play have a case to answer?
I think it's the same situation as it has been all season for David Moyes, which is moments of sheer brilliance from his side to get themselves into position, and then a little bit of negativity maybe to regress back into a side that sat back. His substitutions, I'm sure, will be questioned, and he'll have to answer that as well. But at times they were magnificent. They made the game what it was.
Yeah, they certainly did. Well, Harvey Barnes is coming off now after doing his TV interviews, much to the cheering of the Newcastle fans who are still here. And why not enjoy the party? Okay, it's time for us now to pick our man of the match from today's game with Enterprise Rent-A-Car.
Man of the match on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Whatever the mission, home or away, Enterprise helps over 120,000 people every day.
Dean Ashton. Got to be Harvey Barnes, the man who's just the last man to leave the pitch.
No. It's the man that got sent off. I thought Gordon
Anthony
was brilliant.
Gordon.
I thought he was so good. He was the threat in the first half. He was crucial in the second half. He even looked injured again and still carried on. Terrific player, terrific performance.
Absolute trooper in what has been an incredible win for Newcastle United here at home against West Ham. That was our man of the match from today's game with Enterprise Rent-A-Car.